Well, welcome to a brand new episode of the Nerdpocalypse Podcast. I'm your host, Jay. I'm here with my co-host, Micah.
Hey.
Jack.
What's up?
And Terrence.
What's going on?
All right, guys. So this is our first episode on video. So welcome, YouTube viewers, or if you're on VidMe. And also, VidMe. Yeah, that's another that's a secret one I put all our stuff on as well.
That's exciting.
So thank you for watching. And obviously, this is going to be because this is the first episode, we're going to give away the entire episode on video for free. However, in the future, it'll just be clips for those of you who are not signed up for our premium content, which you can go to at thenerdpocalypse.com/premium. All right, it's $5 a month or $50 for the full year. All right, so let's get right into it. So I wanted to talk, so we normally do a section called Checked Out. This week, the biggest thing all of us saw, Fast and the Furious 8, or The Fate of the Furious.
Yeah.
Terrence, you're the only one who saw it last time. So I wanted to kind of, now that all four of us have seen it during the fan meetup that we had, which was great, I want to talk about it and then talk a little bit about spoilers. So we'll give warning before we do that. I'll start with Jack and go around. What did you think, Jack?
You shouldn't start with me first. Because I'm probably least enthused about it. I mean, I really liked it. It was good. I mean, it was entertaining. It was everything you wanted from a Fast and Furious movie, but those movies are insane. Starting to go off the rails a little bit. Like
starting.
Okay, those movies have gone off the rails a little bit.
That happened in part 5, 6.
I don't know, man. There's just some of it that was just like a little superhero movie, little tropey and just kind of stupid, and like Roman he's on the car door and gets pulled out of the Arctic Sea, and then he's dry in the next scene. Like, come on. I don't know.
He was going that fast.
I guess, and he was that furious.
Yeah, thank you.
So, really, but I mean, all in all, it was good. It was a little bit too long. I think if you want to nitpick at it, it's like two hours and 15
yeah,
minutes.
Yeah, it's a bit long.
And I would have liked to have seen the post-credit scene that Vin Diesel cut out.
Yeah. Because his
gotta get the DVD or Blu-ray. That's what
I hope they put it on there, right?
Blu-rays.
I'm sure they'll
put it on there.
Yeah, because they, you know, apparently for what Jack is talking about, if you're not aware, apparently they cut the scene because The Rock and Vin Diesel have their like fucking issues or their personal issues.
Beef.
So it was, I guess, a scene that was kind of helping to spin off like the idea of The Rock and maybe Deckard Shaw. Jason Statham's character into another movie, which, you know what?
I would go see that.
I would see that.
They were two of the best parts of the movie.
I think the rumor was that the Rock wanted a lot more screen time and wanted to be a bigger part of like the movie itself. And Vin Diesel was like, yo, this is my franchise.
What fucking screen time did he want?
Yeah,
If I'm not mistaken, he got more screen time than Vin Diesel did this go around, just because Vin Diesel was...
He had way more speaking time.
Yeah.
Like, he said a lot.
He had all the best parts in the movie.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Punching a fucking steel wall and everything else that he did was insane. Like,
benching he's a fucking superhero, man. Like, how much more do you need, man?
Look, like, he's franchise Viagra, not franchise, I'm going to stand over here to the side. Like, you know, this is what I do.
I don't know. I'd be a little salty if I was Vin Diesel, too. Like, I've been sticking it out. Through the bad years.
Well, he wasn't.
Right. Yeah, no shit.
Wasn't he out of like the?
Technically,
he wasn't in the second.
Technically, he was in Tokyo Drift.
Yeah. What? He was?
Yeah, he came at the very end, and he was like,
up in a fucking
He's in it.
That counts.
I guess I forgot all about that.
It's technically true, which is the best way to.
I guess
be,
that's
you know,
what
right.
things. Whatever.
Fine. Yeah, I think he only missed Too Fast, Too Furious. If I'm not mistaken.
Oh, that's right.
Which was noticeable, because that movie was horrible. Like, it was really bad, and I can't believe I'm saying this, but like, wow, Vin Diesel not being in a movie is is hurting it, which is ridiculous to say, but because he just
that's
you know,
what Ludacris and that nigga name
Tyrese
yeah. I was just gonna say that
that's what
was noticeable for yeah.
But you know what, look, those two characters, like, they were okay in the beginning of the franchise. They've become really fucking good now. Like, Tyrese was fucking hilarious.
Yeah, he's really good in these movies, but, like, he's an asshole.
No, he is.
In every other aspect of his personality.
Yeah.
He's got problems that he needs to shut the fuck up. But
I agree.
Did you know that that also that there was going to be like a little bit between the two of them and the girl at the end? Like, I thought it was pretty clear that she was.
Yeah, I was.
Well, hold on. But let's not talk spoilers just yet. But yeah, I agree. Sorry. With you. Yeah, I agree. I was wait, what?
That doesn't make any
sense. It didn't make any sense. So, Micah, your thoughts on the movie overall?
It's not my favorite, but it. It's fucking ridiculous. It's Fast Furious. Look, I'm invested now.
Yeah, right.
No, like, I gotta see these movies.
Yeah, this is what the
this is the
38th one.
I don't know. Yeah, so it was it did everything I wanted it to do. I saw it twice and I enjoyed it both times.
That's right, you did.
I wanted
to see it twice. But
it's
fuck up.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's a ridiculous series that I cannot believe is being made and continuing to be made, but people keep throwing money at it. So fuck it.
Yeah, right. People are going to go see
How
it.
How many other franchises have over 7 films besides like
Harry Potter? Harry Potter's the big one.
Star Wars.
I was going to say James Bond.
Yeah.
They got like 29 James Bond, of those.
Harry Potter
27.
Something
like in horror movies.
Right.
Yeah. Like the Nightmare on Elm Street movies.
Yeah. They're like 9
Halloween.
Halloween.
Yeah.
They're like 8 of those a piece.
Not a lot of action movies.
But like and sequential, right? Like the James Bond movies are slightly in their own kind of thing.
Because
they're all separate stories kind of thing. This is one this is an epic.
Yeah, I think
it's a saga.
Yeah, so you have
the Furious saga.
Jesus.
So you have Harry Potter and you have the Fast and the Furious movies.
Yeah.
As like
I think
a continuous story.
I think the Fast and the Furious, I don't know, I'd have to check, but I think the Fast and the Furious movies have overtaken the Harry Potter movies as far as money. I think so.
Oh, absolutely.
I'm sure. There may still be more American Ninja movies, however.
No, there's only 4.
Man, your American Ninja game is strong.
Yeah. By the way,
are you sure?
Look, side note, I don't know why I know this, but all of the American Ninja movies are available on YouTube, released by the studio for free.
Really?
Yes.
Cool. You know what I'm doing as soon as we get out of here.
Yeah, fucking Michael Dudikoff. What's that?
Isn't that what studio is that?
Oh, the shitty one.
That I can't remember the name right now.
No, it was Canon.
Canon. Yeah,
was it Canon?
Yep.
Yeah, they were going to make Spider-Man.
Yeah, they were going to have Michael Dudikoff as Spider-Man.
How old was he at that point?
Not the age of Spider-Man, and more importantly, it's Michael Dudikoff as Spider-Man, which is ridiculous. Like. Really? The American Ninja guy? Like, they should have made the black dude from American Ninja Spider-Man.
Oh, I would watch awesome. That. Yeah.
He died.
Complete with afro. Oh, he did?
Yeah, like of liver cancer a couple years ago. That's again, crazy. My American Ninja knowledge is way too
I've never seen
I'm pleased to say that I have never, I don't know anything.
Really?
Really?
Do yourself a favor.
Yeah, dude, they're awesome.
Yeah,
and by awesome, I mean they're perfect
bad.
For No Time to Bleed. But they're insane. They have different colored ninjas for different.
Oh, yeah. There was like, they were like yellow
Power
and
Rangers?
Pink in one of them.
Yeah, I mean, look, they kind of are. They just don't fight aliens. They just like muscle drugs around the islands.
I don't even remember what the plot of any of those movies were.
No, I think you probably, if you did, that means like, I don't know, your brain is waste. It's wasted space. Even I don't.
I mean, it already is, but
yeah.
Not that bad apparently.
So for me, Fast and Furious was, again, like Micah said, it was not my favorite, but I certainly did enjoy it. I laughed my ass off. That movie has so many scenes that are so utterly ridiculous. The scene with Roman, you know, stuff like that, and we'll get into the spoilers and stuff. It was just utterly ridiculous. But I will say this, and this is a really bizarre thing to say. I actually kind of miss Paul Walker in this movie.
Yeah, I did. The new white guy was awful. Scott Eastwood?
Scott Eastwood.
How bland and
yeah, he's
and
Clint Eastwood's son. You know that?
Yeah, he just doesn't.
No.
He doesn't have it.
And like Paul Walker's not the greatest actor.
I would argue that is very true.
Again, I will defend Running Scared.
Yeah, that's a very I will
because he was very good in that movie.
Yeah.
But he's not good. But he brought something to the movies.
I think it's because he was a straight guy, right? Like you've got Roman and Tej, who are the sort of comedic elements, right? Or like the weird tech nerd, idiot guy who's here. Element of the movie. You've got Vin Diesel and The Rock, who are like the tough guys. Letty is like the love story slash tough chick. And then Brian was kind of like, hey guys, things are happening.
He had a really good intense face.
Yeah, he was like the glue of the team.
I believed that he was into it.
Yeah.
You know what
yeah,
I mean? Like
yeah,
he,
yeah. yeah, I agree with that.
Because he was a part of this franchise from the beginning, like I think he felt like it was his, mm-hmm. much like Vin Diesel feels like
yeah,
this is his.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I agree with that.
Yeah.
So, you know.
And he was, the only one he wasn't in was in Tokyo Drift, right?
Yeah, the only one, yeah. Yeah. yeah.
He Tokyo was in all Drift. Of them except for Tokyo Drift.
Yep. What was he doing during Tokyo Drift, I wonder?
Running scared? Probably.
Maybe about the same time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So he was like, "I'll take a break.
Yeah,
I don't want to hamstring myself in this series. I don't know what's gonna happen with my career." Turns out, you better get back to the fucking Fast and Furious. You don't have that long.
God damn it!
Well, he didn't. He died in a car crash, which is fucking sad.
Wow.
Okay. He didn't,
dude. I shed tears at the end of that. Movie, dude, when that song came on and dude, he starts seven, driving away. That couple tears
didn't
came
cry.
Out.
I didn't cry because I'm a man, but like, yeah, you set yourself up for that one.
Yeah.
But. I did, like, I like in my cold, dead heart. Like, I felt a little bit. I was just like, ooh,
oh, I just got fucked
like, up. Like, it actually kind of made me feel sad. Yeah, and then in this movie, they're like, oh, we're not going to, you know, we're not going to get Brian out of retirement or whatever. And I was just like, oh, you got me, Vin. You got me. Like, it's right there, man. But, like, you actually do miss his character in the movie.
Yeah, you really did. Yeah. It was noticeably absent.
Yeah. Scott Easton, look, I don't know. I'm sure he'll show up in more. I'm sure they'll, with him and Kurt Russell's character, they'll keep them there. But he's got a bit of a way before they can sort of fill the shoes of.
Is that what he was supposed to do? Because I feel like
they were like, we don't have.
We don't have a white guy.
We don't have a white guy on the team.
They need somebody for Tyrese to play off of that's not Tej.
Yeah.
Like, Tyrese needs a buddy.
Yeah, that's fair.
You know.
That's not Tej. But and it was funny because, like, the very idea of Scott Easton in this movie was kind of like...
Eastwood.
Eastwood, excuse me.
Whatever.
That's how forgettable.
Get your white people name straight.
Scott Eastwood. I mean, Easton. And that fucking... That's a magazine where they sell fucking
it is. Like East Bay.
There it is.
Fucking basketball shorts that I'll never buy. But like he was just kind of forgettable. Obviously, I didn't even remember his name. But what was interesting is as forgettable as he was as a character, Tyrese's character was so good at playing off of him. Like that was the weird thing. It was like he was playing off of like a bland piece of wood, but he was written so fucking well. I think this is the best Tyrese we've seen in the franchise.
I don't
by
think
far.
They even write his shit anymore.
They're just like, go for it.
Go ahead, nigga. Like, whatever.
You got it.
You're like the dude in Class.
Yeah.
That just riffs off of people.
But you know
That's
what?
Pretty much all he does.
I mean, he was really good. Like, I have to say, he was one of my, I wouldn't say favorite parts, but I certainly enjoyed
him. Tyrese's best acting is done in fucking Fast and Furious.
That is.
Man, this
that
movie's
a
done
fact.
A lot of weird things that are like bests and firsts and
yeah.
who the fuck ever
Don't
saw
Don't read
that
ahead.
Coming.
Don't read ahead. Which
Shit,
is one,
man.
One of the most ridiculous phrases is going to get said tonight.
Right.
So let's talk quickly spoilers for just a minute or two. So if you're listening, we're gonna talk spoilers.
Yeah, we're about to spoil the Fast and Furious.
Yeah. Right. So
whatever.
I thought one of the best scenes is surprisingly not in the cars, which is the jailbreak scene with
That's the
best Rock
part.
And Jason Statham.
Absolutely.
Yo, this nigga ripped a fucking sink out of the wall and fucking curled it.
No, it was a bench.
It was a
cement
it was
bench.
A cement whatever yeah. it was. It yeah. was cement. He ripped it off the wall and curled it.
No,
yo,
why? For effect. Just
why?
For intimidation.
Well, he was punching the wall first before he did that.
Hold up. Jason, one of our listeners who flew in from Colorado. Like,
shout out
to
the
fucking
Jason.
Yeah,
you're
yeah,
the
no
fucking
shit.
Man.
Yeah, yeah.
He flew from Denver to come watch the movie.
He's
and then he left the same day.
Yeah, that's true.
He's a wrestling fan, like all of us, right?
Yes.
This dude pointed out
well,
something.
Well, hold on. You got to set up the scene for that, too.
Right, I will. He pointed out something that I am ashamed that as a wrestling fan, I did not see until he said it.
I hadn't heard anyone say this, by
right.
the way. No one.
So there's a scene of The Rock walking up like a giant carrot in an orange jumpsuit, handcuffed and being walked into the jail. Mr. Nobody, played by Kurt Russell, and Little Nobody, played by Scott East Bay, is there, right? And Scott East Bay is talking all this shit. And he's like, well, if you're not going to do it for your country, do it for your daughter. Quite literally, The Rock grabs Scott East Bay, turns that son of a bitch sideways and pushes him up against the wall. He literally turned that son bitch sideways.
Dude. And so we're sitting in the theater.
Oh shit!
I mean, yeah, like I didn't catch that, right? Like, I mean, I saw he was sideways, but like we're sitting in the theater. It's Micah, me, and Jason, and that scene happens, and Jason just goes, "He literally turned that son of a bitch sideways," and we both looked over and just fucking lost it. Like, it is a perfect fucking moment, dude.
That's crazy. I didn't catch that shit until you just said it.
Yeah.
He lifted him up like he was a fucking toy.
Yep.
And just turned like him sideways and put him up on the wall. I'm like, okay. So you're the Incredible Hulk at this point.
Yeah. And I mean, that's what literally, you said last week, right?
Like, he was the fucking Hulk.
Like, he curled a concrete bench. Not for like, I need to curl this to get out of prison. He curled it to intimidate Jason Statham. Like, I'm really strong. Yeah, nigga, I see you. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? But that scene was really fucking fun because it was The Rock just eating rubber bullets. They just like shooting me. He's just like,
oh my God,
that was a bad idea. I'm like, what do you mean it's a bad idea? Like, you're not a superhero. This is not okay. And then he just proceeded to get into a fight with Jason Statham, which was great. And just beating up random jail residents. It was great. I enjoyed it.
I love that scene.
That's good. It was really good. Vin Diesel, what did you guys think of the reason why Vin Diesel turns on people? Because they captured his kid that he didn't know he had. I thought it was a pretty decent turn. I didn't mind that. It didn't seem ridiculous. I was hoping for a clone, since he's basically a soap opera.
Yeah, yeah. No,
like, just, dude, why are you like trying to be reasonable? Fucking shoot for the moon. Yeah, literally, right. No, exactly. In the 10th one.
It was fine, I guess, though.
To quote Vin Diesel,
he literally grumbled his way through the vast majority of the scenes. He's like, you don't have any, what was it, Charlize Theron? She's like, you don't have a choice. And he's like, I don't have a choice. I was like, why are we screaming? Like, we're all right here.
She caught me off guard. I'm like, why is he screaming? She's right there.
Like, that's like a weird jump scare.
Right, it was. She kind of shook me a little bit.
This is almost as weird as her hair for the first time.
What?
Like,
why
was going on?
Not a fan
with the dreadlocks.
No, like, look,
not a fan of that at all.
Charlize Theron, like, you're too fine already.
Settle down.
Just keep what you got going on.
She was an effective villain, though.
She was good.
I thought she was pretty good. Yeah. And it's kind of cool that she didn't get captured or die. So clearly, she'll probably come back in the 10th or something.
Yeah.
That ending was very similar to fucking XXX jumping out of a fucking plane.
For the villain or whatever?
Yeah, I didn't like that. Because that movie sucks.
Yeah, well, I think he was trying to weirdly turn that into another Fast and
Furious
franchise.
Oh, yeah, he was. Because the whole fucking
family
United Color of the Benetton bullshit, it didn't work in XXX.
I feel like you're going to get another one of those movies.
I feel like they don't need to do that shit at all. Because that shit was garbage.
The one of the things I didn't like about the movie is Vin Diesel smiling.
His teeth are.
You want to talk about fucking smiling? That nigga smiled through the entire movie in XXX.
It's not a thing that he needs to do.
I'm like, shut, yo, stop.
Like that's when not they, your, that's when your tough that's guys, not your thing. When tough guys who like feel like they have to be super tough, like right. When they smile, like it's just like teeth gnashing. It's like,
you know what it is?
That is fucking terrifying, dude.
Yeah, you're freaking me out. You know what it is? It's that scene in fucking Terminator 2 where like Arnold, or I think maybe 3, where he's like, yeah, no, you need to smile. And he's like, I'm a robot. I don't fucking know. Sorry.
Like, and when they did it at the end of the movie, like, it is a tight shot of Vin Diesel and Jason Statham. Jason Statham, man, he ain't
British.
No smiler either. Mm. And he's British. They don't have fluoride.
Yeah.
Like, whoa, what the fuck? No. Never smile.
Yeah. Pull the camera back. Look, there are two rules in action movies. Tough guys don't look at explosions and don't smile. These are the only rules you have. Everything else is open. Like that, as far as I'm concerned.
I think just for me, the thing that bothered me the most about the entire movie is such a little thing, but you had the perfect comment. I was like, why'd they name him Brian?
Thank you.
Because Brian's still alive. There's no real reason.
Right, yeah. That makes sense.
And then Michael was like, they should have said Paul. And I was like, yeah, fucking thank you. They should have named
him Paul. Paul would have been good. Or if you're doing a character inside the movie universe, Han would have been a good name.
Right, but if you're gonna do Paul Walker, I mean, again, they should have just named him Paul. They should have
named him Paul.
Yeah. And it would have been a fan thing. They didn't have to acknowledge it in the movie. They could have just named him Paul. And they just never said another thing about
his name is Paul Walker Toretto. Really? That seems weird.
What was his middle name? I forgot.
Marcus.
Marcus.
Marcus. Brian Marcus Toretto.
Is Marcus the name
of something De La Cruz or some shit like that? I thought his mother name.
No, it was
his mother gave him the middle name.
Yeah, it was Marcus. It was Marcus.
Was it?
Yeah.
Which is oddly like very black. Like just a black American name.
Well, I mean, what the fuck is
But she's like Brazilian.
Vin Diesel was black.
Marcus could be a Brazilian name, I guess.
Is it?
Did you say black or Rican?
I don't fucking know what he is.
That feels racist.
Whatever.
That's fair.
So you know what's gonna happen, right? You know what's gonna happen, especially now that he named his kid Brian. Like Fast 9 is gonna take place like 16, 17, 18 years in the future. And it's gonna be Dom and Brian back together.
I mean, look, somebody made that comment in our fan group, the nerdpocalypse.com/fans. Somebody made that comment that they should spin it off, like, or do like a fast forward where Brian is older, like he's in his 20s or something like that, and then he starts his own fucking crew, which I, by the way, I have no problem with, but it would be a little weird because they would all look the same. It's like, this has been 15 years. I'm like, wow, black, brown really doesn't crack. Like, everyone still looks like they're 38. Like, that's kind of weird.
Except Scott Eastwood, because he's white.
Yeah, they would just replace Scott Eastwood with Clint Eastwood. He's like, he's 38 years old. Like, oh,
like, why does he look 97 years old?
You just get another white guy. We all look the same.
That's true.
Just kind of.
Thanks for coming in, Brad.
What do you guys think about the ending?
ending.
God damn.
Man. The ending where they gave him a hug with their cars. Is that what you're talking about?
No, I mean the entire
scene. On the ice?
Like
thing?
On the ice.
That was fucking crazy.
One? Oh, it was absolutely crazy.
That part,
I loved it.
Was insane. But which movie had the more outrageous physics? Was it this one or was it Seven?
Now, see, you asked me that when we came out of it.
What's the ending for Seven?
Seven was the one when he fucking shot a goddamn helicopter out of the sky with explosives. Like, which one had the more insane ending? This nigga smashed on the...
On a parking garage. Yeah,
he collapsed the parking garage by stomping it.
No, you know what?
He ramped his car.
Six is a more ridiculous ending.
Oh, with the 19?
They were on a runway for 45 minutes. I just watched it the other day. It's like 30 minutes.
Yeah, it's a very long runway.
It was a
runway.
700-mile runway that goes from, I don't know, Atlanta to fucking Sweden. I don't know.
You never seen ridiculous. That? It's there.
So which one is...
Travel.
Like, see honestly, some shit. I feel like they kind of grounded this one.
It seemed more reasonable.
Yeah, when they were almost body slammed by a fucking submarine. Yeah, it's a lot more reasonable than driving on the edge of a building.
The submarine is still underwater.
He jumped
his Dodge, which, by the way, that fucking car was awesome.
That was like a Mad Max car.
Yeah, that shit was badass.
Yeah.
But he jumped a car over a submarine, but hit the side of the submarine, so he literally curved his car in midair. I mean, I guess it was reasonable. I guess it was.
But which one was more outrageous?
I don't know. They're all insane, but I love them.
I feel like this one was slightly more grounded in reality.
Look, I don't buy...
Outside of the zombie, that sequence was fucking crazy.
Oh, I loved it.
Zombie sequence.
Yeah. That was good.
Chasing, it looked like 28 Days Later.
Yeah, when they came around the fucking corner, they all slid. I was like, run, nigga, you're gonna die. Like, that shit was good, man. I actually really dug that.
It was a smartly written Fast and the Furious movie. Cannot believe I'm saying that out loud.
That alone is the most ridiculous thing you said, but not the most ridiculous thing that we'll talk about with that movie
tonight.
That's
true. Yeah.
Even like the sequences where they were just talking with each other, they weren't terrible. Like
it wasn't a badly written movie.
Ridiculous. Like, the downtime was even decent before they fucking started doing crazy shit with cars.
With zombie cars.
And it's you've got to say that hands down it's the most diverse cast.
Yeah, and that's the other thing.
And that's literally like and look, that will play into another story that we talk about, which is the bigger story on one of the biggest stories on the docket. But yeah, the diverse cast, I mean, it is legit. They had to bring in a white guy because it was like,
yeah, the white guy.
There might be too much brown on this list, guys. Yeah. Like, I don't know. We need a white guy
you always need one.
Balance this out.
And have one. Get you out of jail.
Yeah, right? You just need one. This is the one to talk to the cops.
Think about it.
Just
I was in a situation.
Like, everyone just like slowly turns to Jack. Is that why I'm here? To help you guys
I don't
out.
Mind being
the police issues.
The first time I ever got drunk was with a bunch of white people, and it kept me from going to jail.
There you go.
See?
Like, literally, we were drunk in a car with a bunch of open alcohol bottles.
I'm sorry, officer. I didn't know I couldn't do that.
The cab pulled up. And we sobered up very quickly, but we were sitting in front of, like, a mansion or whatever.
I don't know what it was.
And, I was the only black guy. And there was open bottles of alcohol in the car.
Oh.
And they let us go.
I
was like, this must be what it feels like to be white.
This is amazing.
I swear to God, I went home and was like, I'm...
Like, this is amazing.
No, I was sober at that time.
Oh yeah.
See, look, real quick,
not the man in 3B.
Seeing cop lights, that'll sober your ass up.
That is right the quickest way to sober.
Yep. Hey,
hello.
Drains right out of you.
How you doing, officer? Like, I didn't.
Good afternoon.
He literally searched through the car and saw them. He saw all of it. Mm-hmm. I was like, how the fuck am I not going
to? He was like, this black guy gave it to you, didn't he? he made you drink it, didn't he?
Yeah, I was like Jared. 10 years older than the white dudes because I just look like, apparently we just look older.
What were you doing with a bunch of white dudes being 10 years older than them?
I was in Ellicott City. No, I wasn't 10 years
older. You just looked like you were.
I look like, well, according to cops, we all look 10 years older than
them. Right.
But I mean, then you do kind of look like you're 45 years old.
little known fact, Terrence, 18.
Yeah, I'm 26. We were all the same age. I was in Ellicott City.
That's another reason why. That is another white spot to be in.
The fact that you didn't get your fucking head cracked in.
I was very shocked. But yeah, white people are good for something.
There you go.
There you go, Jack.
You're good for lots of things, man. Come on. I'm not going to take good for something.
Colonization.
Like bullshit.
Did you listen to our
appropriation? A lot of things.
You should listen to our preview episode of this.
That's I might have said. The rumors might indicate that I said that white people don't exist. Anyway, moving right along.
That is something that was said and was hilarious.
That's awesome.
You should listen to the
bigots here, man.
Well,
really?
Huh?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know what you're
talking
about.
Just that side of the table. This side of the table over here.
I listened to that show too.
Yo, wow. So that is a fucking racial heel turn if I've ever seen it. Oh, fuck.
Those three jackasses on that show.
Yeah, exactly. Really? Wow. We should think about the coal miners. No, we shouldn't. Now.
Overall, Fast Fate of the Future.
It was fun, man. I really enjoyed it. I will see a ninth one, without a doubt.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'll see all of them.
When it's underwater.
I don't fucking care
last thing on this. I don't really buy Blu-rays very often because everything is streaming at this point.
Yeah.
And I don't like rewatch a lot of movies anymore. I will, without a doubt, when they bring out the Blu-ray set of all 10 of these movies, I will buy them.
They had a Blu-ray set for $27 on Amazon last week for the first 7.
Yeah, but why buy it? You know they're going to keep doing more of them.
I don't know.
It's dumb. No.
It was like the lithograph set and all that other bullshit. But no. I was like, I might pick this up.
Yeah, I need to get those 4K TV. Fast and the Furious lithographs.
Guys, I really need this in my collection.
Serious.
Somebody's going to buy it.
All I know is the box set better come.
$27.
Right, that's right. What it brings, man. Yeah. All I know is the box set better come with a fucking chain that Vin Diesel wears, and a fucking wife beater that he wears. That's where they should go. That should be the extra.
It comes with an empty Corona, a necklace, and a wife beater.
Empty Corona.
Love it. Can I skip over the first driving sequence?
Look, because we got to move on.
I know,
but dude, that shit. He drove an old car in Cuba on fire backwards and beat a guy in a race. The engine was so hot it was literally red.
Yeah.
That was the first 5 minutes
that
of the movie.
That was literally the first 5 minutes of the movie. I'm like, well, I know where we're going from here.
The windshield explodes in, and he's just like,
fire. Fireproof.
It's fine.
That's his
shards of flaming hot glass.
That's fine. That's quite all right. Later on, he was saved by a family hug of colors. Fuck you. Fucking movie. Let's move into science and tech this week. So this is kind of a super interesting story. Neuroscientists have come up with a way to upload knowledge to your brain. This is
Matrix
pretty,
style.
Yeah, like they literally reference the Matrix in this article a number of times. So basically, they put like this kind of cap on your head that kind of does like really super light electroshock therapy, kind of like electro stimulation. Like you barely feel it.
That's what they tell you.
That's what they tell you, right? If you're crazy and they put you in a padded room, you feel a little bit more, I guess. Mm-hmm. But the idea is, if you, they did this with pilot, like people learning to be pilots, right? So they mimicked the electric, you know, the activity of actual like learned pilots who were like professionals. And then they did those same shocks on people who were learning to be pilots mm-hmm. while they were like studying and while they were practicing and shit like that. And they learned, you know, what they were being taught, like 30 to 40% more than an average person learning. Mm-hmm. Or learn it 30 to 40% faster, which is kind of interesting, right? So they think like this is the start of being able to do kind of like that matrix, like jack in, like here.
Yeah, yeah.
How do I fly a helicopter? You know, you have the fucking knowledge. My question is, if you had that ability, would you do it?
Yes.
You goddamn right.
Instantly.
Yeah, I'm pretty lazy.
Right. Right. Okay. But do you see any cons with it? Because I see kind of a one huge con.
Yeah. Well, everybody can't be good at everything, and also it would come down to dollars, right? The people with the most money.
Let's say it's ubiquitous and it's inexpensive.
I don't know. Then we'd all be perfect. You can't have that.
Here's my thing. It would be. It could possibly lead to the collapse of society that everybody knows everything. Right. Like, okay.
No more specialization.
Right. Okay. Like we, you know, this studio, for instance, like I'm not a carpenter. I fucking hired someone to come in and do it. Illegal immigrant. That's spoiler alert. He's really fucking good.
Built steps in 20 minutes.
He kind of did. But that being said, like if I knew how to do that, if I could learn how to do that, then I would have just done it myself, right? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But if I do that, then let's say like then his business collapses. Like if I know how to make 5-star dinners, like that collapses. You know, like all those kind of things. Like society starts to fall. Like businesses start to fall away.
Yeah, yeah, but I think you're underestimating one thing: is that people really are lazy. Like, yeah, I know how to do things.
That's fair.
I don't feel like doing it.
Yeah, like who was gonna want to build this?
Right. Like exactly.
Yeah. All right.
Like know, even like, if you knew how to do it, would you spend the time?
I would pull a mic. I would take a wad of cash and I would throw money at the fucking problem. Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
Because nothing stopped you from learning how to do this. You did it because you wanted to do it.
Yeah.
Nothing could stop you from learning how to build those steps over there. You didn't want to do it.
Yeah. All right, that's a fair point. That's point, counterpoint. Like,
some people just don't like cooking.
Yeah.
Like, even if you knew how to do it, I'm like, I don't feel
yeah,
like
I mean, it's, I, yeah, I suppose the time-consuming thing is. I was just thinking about that. Like, but, okay, things that don't take you a long time. Like, okay, like web programming or something like that. Not that that doesn't take a long time, but like if you could do those things, would you still hire somebody? Like if you could save, like, okay, getting like carpentry work done costs a decent amount of money because it takes a decent amount of time.
Yeah.
I feel like I would be motivated by my cheap. I think my cheapness overshadows my laziness. I'd be like, yeah, I could hire someone to like do the podcast and all that other shit, but you know what? Free if I do it, like,
well, it's not free, you still gotta buy the materials,
yeah. But I would still have to do that either.
Well, you know what would happen,
I guess
you know what would happen. Society wouldn't necessarily collapse, it would slow down. But, old people physically can't do shit,
yeah. That's fair.
So, there would still be a certain area for, but at the same token, like, all these old people know what the fuck you're doing. So,
it would be a nightmare.
You better come correct.
Yeah, it would be a nightmare.
Complain their ass off.
Yeah, customer service would be the biggest fucking problem, right? Because people would be like, look, motherfucker, I'm a master carpenter. I don't feel like building that wall, but I know where the screws go. Like, I feel like that would kind of be
like, I know how much the materials cost.
Yeah, you couldn't screw anybody. You couldn't screw anybody.
I'm like, well, you're not going to do it. So, either you're going to take it or do it your goddamn self.
Terrence, master of customer service.
You have no idea how much he's lying right now.
Okay.
Oh yeah. I'm great at customer service. Continue. Fuck that. No, you're not. No.
Am I not?
Look, goddamn. I couldn't hold it in anymore.
Look, listen, I am very good at customer service.
If you're a new listener,
Terrence, and I was Terrence's boss at one point in a retail environment. Yes. And
GameStop. What?
Yep. It was a place where you could stop at where you could purchase games.
Yes.
And right. Terrence's customer service was legendary, but not for being the best. I don't. You would, dude, you would literally laugh at people when they would ask you questions. Hold.
Did that or did that not happen?
I don't know what you're talking about.
All right, then it happened. I really don't.
Now, look. If you ask a stupid question, then you might get a chuckle because that was a stupid question. But I would answer it.
You would, eventually.
I would answer the question.
Look.
Ask me a stupid fucking question.
It isn't a question answering service. It's a customer service. Like, you can't just be like, yo, that's dumb. Anyway, this game is $59.99.
Like, can I get a discount?
Yo, that's dumb. You're dumb. It's pronounced GTA 5.
I didn't say that. I never said that. But
did you want to?
I probably did. But the one thing that used to drive me crazy, we used to have to buy two, get one for
free. Uh-huh. Yeah, and people didn't understand that
like,
at all.
They'd be like, yo, let me get this $60 game and let me buy these $2 games. I'm going to pay $4 for this and give me this $60 game. Like, and I used to be like, yo, come on, son.
it doesn't work like that.
You really know that doesn't work that way, though. Like,
wait, they thought that you could buy the cheaper product.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Dude. Yeah. Man, we can sit down and tell you stories for hours.
I never did.
Yo, I'll be like, come on, yo.
I worked.
You know goddamn well that's not how. Yo, and that's what I was. I'm like, you know that's not how it works.
I worked really hard for 4 years to keep Terrence employed just because of how entertaining he was and how much I enjoyed having him around.
I was good.
You were good at your job.
I was very good.
Interacting with people is not your number one skill is all I'm saying.
It's
number three? Seven?
Number eight?
I don't know.
Look, but people enjoyed my company.
Absolutely. Dude, I'm telling you, I enjoyed your company.
That's why you worked for me. That was literally the worst like version of I'm really good at customer service. Well, yeah, people enjoy my company.
People like me.
They did.
Like your coworkers or the customers.
Everybody.
Coworkers and the customers.
Yeah.
You trail off a little bit there when you said customers. But like your heart wasn't in it.
I used to work in fucking Liberty.
All right, that's fair.
There's a certain clientele. Like I could relate to the people, if you will.
Yes.
Like, I'm a nigga. I don't want to tell you.
Fair enough. Welcome, new listeners.
Sorry.
It is what it is.
So, yes, I would be interested in putting new knowledge in my brain.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I would be, like, I don't have any addictions, per se, but I feel like I would be absolutely addicted to, like, learning new shit.
If you could only do one thing, what would you pick?
Ooh, that's a good
skill.
Can I learn teleportation?
No. Sadly.
I mean, well, you could learn quantum physics and then you could figure it out.
Mm. I can do one thing, right?
You can get one ultimate knowledge.
I would want to know all languages.
That's the right answer.
Hmm.
That's the right answer.
That is pretty good.
Yeah. Because you can literally go anywhere in the world.
Right. Yeah. What's the one thing that causes arguments all the time? Like miscommunication.
Yeah.
Fucking dummies tweeting about shit. Like, well, I really didn't know what I was saying in my 44 spaces that I'm 144 spaces.
I was like, well, if somebody does not use
Twitter. I don't tweet, guys.
Guys, they're only up to 44 characters on Twitter.
44 spaces? What?
Whatever. Well, a space is a character, right?
It is.
It's a blank character.
Don't try to clean it up. You're still 100 off, by the way. Plus images.
So all languages, but what would you do with it?
Anything I want.
Yeah, but you're still broke.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
you can't go nowhere.
I can go places.
Not fast enough. Not with all those languages you know.
I can go places. Look,
if they don't speak a different language in Virginia and DC. That shit, I mean, maybe.
Nigga, that's what they do.
I'm about to say.
You know what? I take it back.
Like DC more so than Virginia.
Yeah. Right.
I don't know what the fuck y'all talking about. I'm in Baltimore.
I have no clue. That's
looking my whole life. Mm. I don't know you people.
All right.
Languages is good though.
That's a good answer.
What would make me the most amount of money?
I was gonna say learn to fly. It's a pretty easy job.
A pilot?
Yeah, that's easy.
But I don't make that much money.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, they do.
How much money do pilots make?
Hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Do they?
Good ones.
Yeah. Yeah, because you have to, you have like 100 and some odd souls.
Yeah, under your care.
More than that. How about this? And you get to like call the cops and have them beat the shit out of an Asian man in the back of an airplane. Whatever. Look, the sky's the limit, really. I don't know. What would be the one thing?
Kung fu.
Manipulation. Is that a skill?
No.
Was this an RPG?
Technically, I mean, if you're like a fucking hypnotist or some shit.
I don't know.
Mentalism is certainly very real.
Social engineering. I would want to be like a computer hacker. Like,
yeah, programming, I guess.
Like L33T.
Don't you work in IT?
Yeah, but I'm dumb.
Don't you hate it?
Yes, but I look.
So why would you want to be?
No. I don't want to work there. I want to use those evil skills to do other things. That's what I want to do.
Like, steal pennies out of people's fucking bank accounts.
Look, half a billion. Look. A quarter
didn't
of a penny.
Did they do that same thing in Superman 4?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
Like
what other movie was it? Office
Space?
Specifically. That was right.
Yeah. Isn't that the plot of Superman 4? Yeah, but it actually worked in the 70s. maybe computer skills. I don't know. Languages, I feel like, is probably the right answer.
Or all the martial arts. I mean.
Yeah, all right, that's fair.
That was my second choice, yeah.
Yeah.
Look, either you could speak to everybody or you could just kick the shit out of everybody.
Yep. Like, if I knew all the martial arts and was really good at it, I am a very docile person unless you shut the fuck up. Unless you touch me. Like, look, I'll yell and scream.
I'm a
very docile person. I'll yell and scream though. And like don't touch me.
Like, I'm a docile person, but the smallest thing of touching me drives me crazy.
No, I mean, you can touch me.
All right. He's calm down.
Anyways.
That's the title of Terrence's debut album.
So like in an aggressive manner. Don't fucking do that.
Yeah.
Would you beat up a guy on a shitty radio show if he disagreed with you on politics?
Maybe. I don't know. No, I wouldn't just hit somebody to hit somebody. But I wouldn't take anybody's shit at all.
No, you don't have to.
Like, look, don't just leave me alone, dude.
I'm right. Well, actually, Terrence, you're wrong. Allow me to show you the list of martial arts styles I could beat you to death with. Oh, okay, it's cool.
You know what I'll take?
Be a good thing for me to have.
I will take all of the sniping knowledge, because therefore you can hunt forever, take down an animal.
I swear, you really don't want to live with society, do you? Like, you are obsessed with this.
I want to get away.
Travel America. Away from you fuckers.
Yeah, like, what is wrong with you?
You're weird.
I don't know, man. I just had enough.
You're very white.
Had enough of civilized America.
Yeah, I feel like... Like, we're all friends. Like, we're all friends, and we've been friends for a number of years. I feel like the end of our story as people will be like... Mike and I will know each other forever because we've known each other damn near forever. Jack will somehow like leave and go to Montana at some point, and we will like he'll show up at like one of our funerals with a fucking mountain man beard. It's like, dude, where have you been? Like, dude, I've been hunting salmon and bears for 38 years. I'm like, wow, that's amazing.
Built my own house on sticks.
I'm gonna fucking end up in Alaska on that goddamn TV show.
It's too cold for me. It's too cold in Alaska.
You say that now.
Yeah, that's true.
Grow that fucking grizzly man beard.
I think I should grow back long. It's getting kind of short now. Kind of get back
it's,
to the
during this summer.
Yeah, dude, you're doing it wrong. Yeah. It's about to be 148 degrees here.
That's true.
Keep it short, dude. And then when the winter comes, grow your fucking hobo beard.
It's a good call.
Like, hey, everybody. Well, you got any meth or spoons?
Have you ever grown a beard in your life? Can you grow a beard?
I can't grow a beard.
I can't.
When are you going to go through puberty? What's going to be my next question?
You know, it's really kind of offensive that you wait until we're on YouTube. Like, fucking throw me directly under a bus.
I actually already knew the answer to that question.
Yeah, I know you did. I know you did.
I've tried.
Yours looks good. You got a pretty good beard.
This is as far as it goes, right?
It can get a little bit more than that, but because I recently shaved.
Fuck you guys.
Mike's got some good scruff going too.
Yeah,
this is about as good as it's gonna get.
That's fair.
Now, in fairness, I just shaved today, but
I feel like you should try.
Shut up.
Let it go.
Look, I have tried every fucking year, every fucking year. Oh, no shave November and all that other shit. And I'm like, yeah, me too, guys. And I'm like, it's November 30th. I'm done.
Call me Patches.
Yeah. Yeah, I look like fucking Anthony Hamilton. It's not a good one. No, he finally shaved his.
Yeah, he did.
I'm like, dude, you need to let this shit go. All right, let's move into stupid tech. All right. So this is the Dream Sling. It's the first sling pillow for travel. So it's one of those like neck wrap pillows, but it also has another piece to it where you put your hands sort of in it, so it holds your hands up so your arms aren't just like hanging down.
Right.
So you look like
an insane person.
So you look like what Donald Trump was impersonating at that rally.
Basically.
Wow.
It is really stupid, but at the same time, I think it's slightly genius.
Do you?
I think it's slightly genius. I would never use it because I have a problem with looking dumb in public. like, you know what I mean? Like, I realize, like, wow, this might actually be beneficial, but I'm like, but I don't want to look like an idiot. Mm. Like, I'm not a style over function type of guy, but I'm a consider style while having a function kind of guy. So.
I don't understand what this is doing. Like, you can fold your arms and lay down.
Yeah, you could, but you could also be one of the 71 backers who has this and have it. It's $50. You're paying $50. It goes from adult sizes small to triple XL.
Watch that first video with the fat guys, because that's the best part.
Yeah, they're fucking gigantic guys. They're like, are you stuck between these two guys?
The production quality of the videos on this
is
pretty well done, I will say. And I want to know how they found these two fat guys, because they clearly were just like, yo, we need the two fattest motherfuckers we can find. Come sit on this plane.
I mean,
they're clearly Samoan.
Yeah.
One of them is. I don't know about the other one.
No, I feel like
Roman Reigns' brother.
They are definitely related to The Rock.
It almost looks like if Andy had like the Bizarro Superman, that would be Bizarro Andy.
Andy, if he was like 14 shades darker.
I don't understand.
Could you sleep that way?
I feel like
with hanging yourself.
Like after having shoulder surgery, like being even in a movie theater and like not being able to move my arms for like 2 hours,
right.
Like my shoulder starts to like really fucking bother me. This, I would wake up and I'd be like, just cut my arm off. Like,
oh, yeah.
Because like right at the fucking shoulder, because my arm would be too restricted for too long. I'd lose my mind, dude. I would probably wake up in the middle and try to like punch one of those fat dudes in the face. But like, I need to get free. Like I would if I had to sit next to these guys on a plane, I think I'd be like, I need another seat.
Oh yeah, get right back.
I'd be like, I'm sorry, look. God bless
Yo,
you.
Yo, this shit long as fuck. This video is incredibly long.
Yeah,
six
look.
Minutes. No.
For Kickstarter? Nah, I don't think so.
Like, what is...
So you guys buying this or no?
No.
I don't even understand.
I don't sleep on planes.
I've never been able to
not?
Either.
Yeah.
What's the furthest you've got flown on a plane? 6-7 hours?
Yeah.
Oof.
Yeah. I've flown 20 hours. No. Go to bed.
You couldn't be... Could you stay up 20 hours on a plane?
Yes.
Like, yeah.
Fuck that.
Mike, yo, I go steal his wall.
Fall right to sleep.
I wish I could do that, man. Out. I can't.
You can't either.
I can't nap during the day. Like, I can't sleep on planes. Like, I can sleep in my bed at night. It's pretty much it, man. I've never been a
nap. Is it the
person.
Daylight? Is it the daylight issue, or is this
maybe it's the sitting up or being around other people, or I don't know what it is.
Jack, you guys don't trust anybody.
It's
like,
a combination. No shit. It's a combination of being around other people. Having someone else take me somewhere, right? I don't know this pilot.
Who the fuck is this guy? Like, all these people around me.
What the fuck does it matter?
No.
Whether you're awake or asleep.
I want to see it coming.
Dude, let me tell you something.
I want to see it coming.
At night,
look,
I can't.
I don't want, if he's going to fucking crash into a mountain,
I'd rather be asleep. Yeah. Guys, we're going to crash into a mountain. Are you up?
Something tells
Mike,
me.
Are you awake?
Something tells me. If that plane's going down, you won't wake up.
Oh, yeah.
No, oh, you yeah, won't. Of course. Feel it. Dude, no, but I hope that I'm not awake.
Yeah.
At night,
take me that sweet dream.
When I sleep in my own bed, I have to close my bedroom door because somebody could fucking, I want to hear him coming.
I do that. Okay, that's fair.
I want to hear him coming.
Yeah, that's true. I do that.
Yep.
I'd hear him coming through my front door, but still, close that door. I got to lock it too.
Yeah.
God damn.
Keep the knife.
I latch the door.
Same thing.
That's right, man.
I latch the door. Like, I feel like if you're going to break into my bedroom, I need time enough to like fucking like, take my fist and just like bash it over your head or something, or a baseball bat or something. I need a board.
I have a machete.
I need a board. Mm. You have a machete in your bedroom?
Yes.
I got a Bowie knife.
And I have a handgun, so I win.
Wow. I don't have anything.
I just won that.
I do want to buy a baseball bat.
Everybody should have a gun.
I want a gun.
Get one while you can before the whites take your rights away.
Yeah, no kidding, man.
I mean, I wasn't at the last meeting, but I got the newsletter.
See, again, Jack is proving his worth. This is the second bit of knowledge. He's like, look, white people are coming for your shit. Like,
I'm like the Scarlet, the Black Widow of the
No, you're more like
podcast.
The canary in the coal mine of white people. Hey, guys, I heard some news. Oh, shit.
You okay? No, I'm going to lay down real quick.
Everybody get out.
The get out challenge with Jack.
I want a gun. Like, okay.
I do not want a gun.
I don't need a gun.
No.
Because I will shoot somebody.
Yeah.
But I'm a docile human being.
Mm-hmm. Okay, moving right along.
Man, you keep saying that. One day it might be true.
Yeah.
It is true.
Okay.
I'm a sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
Gross.
Mm. You are very nice.
I like that you go on the internet and tell lies. That's my favorite thing about you.
Terrence is funny. That's the best thing about Terrence.
I'm not that funny.
You are a liar.
You have a good sense of humor.
Yep.
I like telling jokes around Terrence.
Me too. He's got a great laugh.
If they're funny, he will laugh.
Yep.
And he's a great audience.
That's true.
If it's not.
If it's not, he'll look you stone cold in the face. Right?
Not when you're his boss. He'll pretend to like you for years until he actually likes you.
He's like, look.
That may or may not be true.
Well, he's like, this white man signs these checks. Yeah, you're hilarious.
He's not too bad.
I'm not.
Comic news this week.
Good job.
Oh, I was waiting. I really didn't want to be the first one to spill on camera. So
yeah, no.
Super awesome if you did that.
No, well,
try harder next time.
My whiskey is empty. Next up in comic news, Spider-Man 2 will reveal the Miles Morales of the primary Marvel Universe.
Mm-hmm.
So this is kind of an interesting story. You put this on the document.
I did. Did you read the first Spider-Man?
I read part of it. I didn't finish it.
Run. It was basically Peter went from the main Marvel universe to the Ultimate Universe, where the Peter Parker of the Ultimate Universe is dead, obviously. So he met with like Gwen and May and Mary Jane, and there was some back and forth, and he and Miles beat up Mysterio, and Peter ended up going back to his main universe. But at the end of it, there was a cliffhanger ending. He gets on the internet, and he's like, oh, I wonder if we have a Miles Morales. And it's just the last panel is him being like, oh, my God. Cut to black. So this new one is basically plans to show what the Miles of the main universe is up to and what's going on with him and reunite the two of them, presumably since they've been running around the main universe together after Battlegrounds or whatever it was.
No, I never thought of that. I wonder what 616 Miles Morales is.
Yeah.
Like. Yeah. It's a clever setup.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm cool with it. I'm very interested. I hope that he's kind of a villain of sorts.
Yeah, yeah.
My guess is he's not going to be like, whoa, he's an accountant.
Right.
Like,
oh my God.
Like, it turns out, like, he's like the homeboy Hydra agent with fucking Captain America or some shit like that.
Oh, there you go.
It could be. I mean,
well, he's got to be somebody we've never heard of, right? Because Peter would know otherwise. So somebody who hasn't been in the main universe before, so.
There you go.
Who knows? It'd be interesting.
Yeah. I'm down for it, man. I look forward to seeing how they pull that off.
I really like the artwork in the first one, too.
I just realized you have a unicorn vomiting on your shirt. Like, I'm just looking at it. What the fuck?
This is one of my favorites. Dude, I put this on just specifically to come here, and I stopped two places on my way here, and I got 6 compliments on this shirt. I'm not making that up. People like the vomiting unicorn. Thanks, Kate. It was a girlfriend gift.
There you go.
Aw.
It was her shirt. Anyway.
No.
I'm just being a dick.
She's
all right.
Your clothes, man. You know, that's one step closer to marriage. Buddy.
Yeah, but the thing is, she's not like,
done, son.
She's outfitting me in vomiting unicorn shirts, so I think I can live with that.
She still bought it.
You got. It's over.
It's okay.
Micah, question of the week responses. Take it away.
For people who say, should that be for people who saw?
Yeah.
The Fate and the Furious. The Furious.
I wrote it.
What's the best option for spinoffs?
I wrote it.
What's the best option for spinoffs for the series? Anthony says, best option, Hobbs and Shaw. Worst option, Dom cutting off the sleeves of all his shirts.
I disagree. That is not the worst option.
God damn it. Bestest option, Hobbs coaching kids soccer, family movie. And the rest of the team are assistant coaches, equipment manager Tej, Roman on orange slices.
That's fucking funny.
God damn it. Stuart says, go back to the Tokyo Drift characters in a J-horror type movie where they battle a cursed street racing car with a ghost driver who steals the souls of people he beat in his races.
Yeah, so but that...
Han.
What's that?
Han.
Yeah, look, that's the 1980s movie The Wraith.
Do we know he's definitely dead, by the way? Like, Han? Is he, like, did we see his body burn up, or is he really, really dead?
I don't think so, but I think he is dead. I mean, you never know.
Jason Statham killed him.
But, you know, the writer...
Right, Jason Statham killed him, and now all of a sudden, oh, hey, we're all buddies now.
Yeah, nobody ever mentioned that in this new movie, by the way.
Seems totally fine.
Like, we ain't working with him. Yes, you are. All right.
I ain't gonna be happy about it.
Right, until well, I am.
Until I learned he was in the military.
Oh, you were in the military.
We cool.
By the way...
That, yeah, right. That was basically that
scene. By the way, that scene where The Rock gets really mad, I forget about... something, and he punches like the steel wall and leaves the imprint.
Yo,
during our when we saw it in the movie during the fan meetup, he punched it. It was like kind of like a surprising moment. He punches it. Someone behind us dropped their phone because they got frightened. They're like, oh shit, The Rock, like, he's coming.
Like he punched that hilarious. Shit so hard, the dude in the theater dropped it. God damn,
that's how The Rock does it.
Jason says, Fast and Furious in space, they meet up with the Guardians of the Galaxy. Everyone gets captured by Thanos, apart from Vin and Groot. It will have it all, action, adventure, and fourth wall breaking jokes. P.S. I've never seen a Fast and Furious film, but I'm sure they're fun. Gustavo says, Fast and Furious plus Ghostbusters where the ghost of Paul Walker is haunting cars and attacking people. So they team up with Lady Ghostbusters to catch him. Jack, why is baseball a boring sport?
That seems random.
It's not a boring sport.
That's a good question.
Yes,
I want an answer.
Gustavo is our sports fan. Who he asks a bunch of
just
a bunch
random
of soccer questions to Kevin Owens over there.
Kevin Owens on our other show.
He really looks like him too now. Now that Kevin Owens has shaved his beard.
Yeah.
Oh really?
Yeah, he kind of does. Mm.
You can check out our video game show, Dense Pixels, wherever you find podcasts.
Rashawn says, there just needs to be two spinoffs, one with Hobbs and Deckard Shaw and Luda and Tyrese. Also, they can bring Han back. Jay, it doesn't have to make sense. They can bring him back.
I love Rashawn, but he needs to learn where Mr. Peary is.
No, he's doing it on purpose. He's being a dick.
He's doing that shit on purpose. Christopher says, Hobbs and Deckard fighting around the world with Lucas Black and Bow Wow's characters from Tokyo Drift hanging out with them, forming a new crew.
Bow Wow was in Tokyo Drift.
Yeah. He sure was.
I've never seen Tokyo
Drift. He drove an incredible Hulk, like Kia Sportage or some shit. Like
Kia Sportage?
He came in last in that race, too, from what I remember.
Yeah, he was in a Kia Sportage.
It was one of the Sportage, but it was one of those box cars. Remember Toyota had the Scion series?
And or the Cube.
Yeah, or the Cube or some shit like that. And then it had like the Incredible Hulk's fist coming out of it
Let's move on. you know how like little Bow Wow still thinks, or he's Bow Wow, right? He thinks he's like important. Like he thinks people still know him. Like you've seen those videos. He's like, oh, I'm in front of all these kids. They don't know it's me. I'm like,
yeah, they really don't.
They don't know who you are because you're not famous anymore. Mm-mm. Mr. Bow Wow.
Malcolm says, race in the future against Marty McFly and the Doc and travel back in time to save Han. Why not either that or space? Have Dom race on Mars.
Yep.
Khalif says, an ongoing gag of Dom, Leonardo, Hobbs, Raphael, Tej, Donatello, and Roman Michelangelo as the Ninja Turtles.
You know what? If the four of them did the voices for those characters, I'd watch the shit out of that.
Oh, me too. Absolutely.
Dude, come on. How did they miss that opportunity? It's so good.
Perfect. Dom is fucking Leonardo.
He's the leader.
He's the leader.
Hobbs, Raphael. Yeah, he got it right.
Yeah, he really got it right.
He got it right, man. Yeah.
You got the nerd as fucking
Tej.
Yeah.
And Roman is the like, hey guys, we're just having fun. Yeah, orange slices.
He's a party. God damn it.
From now on, Tyrese will be known as Orange Slices.
Jeremy says, I'd like a short of the two Brazilian teammates from Fast Five that made a cameo in Fast Eight. I like those guys. They were funny. It was nice to see them back. Khalif comes back and says, Cyber Thrillers, since Cypher knows Ramsey, Tej, and her can team up, for their own missions.
I'm fine with that. That's not bad.
Juan says, obviously Hulk or Hobbs and Deckard Shaw, but I would watch a Luda Tyrese and Missandei comedy. Oh, that's Ramsey's.
I was like, who? Corinne Bailey Ray?
Yeah. Yes. That's her Game of Thrones
character. Dude, she fucking looks like Corinne Bailey Ray. She's adorable.
Leopoldo says, jumpstart older vehicles based on the franchise. Fast and Furious Present, Knight Rider, Fast and Furious Fast and Furious Present, Dukes of Hazzard, Fast and Furious Present, Airwolf.
I'd watch the shit out of that. I'd watch the shit out of Airwolf, yeah. Dude. Oh, yeah.
And Leonardo says, he should have named the baby Han.
Yes.
We already went over that. It should have named the baby Paul.
Or Paul. I think Paul actually is the better answer.
Fucking Paul Han Toretto.
You know what?
Fine. Or Han Paul Toretto. Sounds better. What rolls off the tongue?
Han, this is my son, Han Paul.
Oh, okay.
That's not weird at all. Good. You're really good at naming, Benjamin.
Thank you, everyone.
All right. So, lightning round this week. They are considering Will Smith to play the genie role in the live action Aladdin movie. Here's my thing. I don't give a shit. I know some people are happy about it. Actually, no, that's not true. Most people are really pissed off about it.
You don't give a shit about Aladdin, live action Aladdin?
No, I don't. I don't give a shit about a live action Aladdin.
I'd see a live action Aladdin if they had like Middle Eastern people.
They said that they are definitely hiring Middle Eastern people. They were like, calm down, everybody. We know white people fuck up a lot. It's not going to be starring like Scott Eastwood.
Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah,
Scarlett Johansson.
Is fucking Jasmine.
I would be offended by that. I would be really offended by it. Look, the obvious choice is Priyanka Chopra. Street Rat, Riff Raff.
Do the live action movies have the
music? The Jungle Book did. Yeah.
Oh, so who's going to sing that? Like, it's going to be
Ryan Gosling.
That's what I mean. This is
Ryan Gosling as Aladdin.
Look.
Somebody look at my face.
This seems like a no-win role. Anybody who takes on the genie
is going to be bizarre.
It's
going to
be tough.
But at the same time,
like, people thinking like that, we wouldn't have gotten Heath Ledger as the Joker. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but then we also wouldn't have gotten Jared Leto as the Joker.
Oh, yeah.
So he's going to be animated.
Damn.
He's
going to
be
counterpoint.
That counterpoint just fucking hit my point right in the balls.
I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, look. Will Smith, I think he could possibly turn it on in like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Will Smith, I could if he can pull that, then yes. It's going to be interesting because it's all live action with clearly one super animated character,
right?
And he's going to really have to nail it.
Insane in that fucking movie,
and you know
Robin Williams.
You know he's going to look like Will Smith,
right?
Like, he's not going to be this big ass like.
That's what I'm about to say. It's gonna be like fucking Shaq from Kazam.
Yeah.
You know what?
But blue.
You know what? Hire Shaq.
Do you guys remember when Hollywood put Shaq in movies?
Yeah,
it was for a time.
The Coke, budget was.
I saw that in the movie theater. By the way,
he was in Blue Chips.
I saw Steel in the movie.
Did you? That was the worst movie.
Whoa! Hold. You saw Steel in the movie theater on a dare?
I think my brother and I went to see it in the movie theater.
Man,
wow, you guys really were starving for black superhero.
The Black Superman, yo.
Yeah.
Oh, how disappointed were you?
Fucking trash.
Yeah, of course.
Dude, man,
he was in a steel suit on a motorcycle.
Dude, that costume looks so bad. Oh man,
like, guys, what the fuck, guys, yo? It's Shaq. I feel like the weight of that, or the springs. The struts on that bike would have to be reinforced, and now he's in a steel suit. It might have to be a little bit more.
Have you seen him lately?
He's a fucking huge guy.
He got really big.
He got fat.
He got fat. He did. He got fat. He did. He did.
I watch him.
He's on NBA on TNT.
Yeah, TNT. Yeah, I watch him.
Does he acknowledge it?
I was too fucking accurate.
No, he's just
a big dude.
He's a big ass dude.
He's like 7'3", 500 pounds.
And he's starting to like. He's starting to settle.
He's pairing out.
He's starting to settle.
Yeah.
And
wasn't he supposed to wrestle the Big Show?
Yeah.
And the Big Show lost like 100 pounds.
Yo, the Big Show was in like really good shape. The
Big Show is has he really? Abs.
What?
Is the best
shape. What?
Wait, like, hold on. Hold on. The Big Show has abs before me? Yo, that's offensive. I'm going to the gym after this. This is some bullshit.
Yeah, he got in like really good shape.
He has Why? Abs?
He has abs.
I imagine his for one his, ab his is the but size
I,
of my
I think he
face.
Wants to live.
Yeah, that's well, fair.
When he's like when you're 7 feet tall, they usually die really young. So he's like I want to live. He should be dead, honestly. He said himself. Like that fucking gigantic whatever the fuck it is.
He is gigantic.
He should be dead.
I mean, he's but over he's 7 feet
fucking
and he's
agile.
Like he's over 7 feet and he's old. He was like over 300 pounds, right? Like 350 something like that.
Yeah.
I
was like 400. Like he was damn near 500 pounds.
Yeah.
Good Lord.
Yeah. 7'3"
I told you that clip I saw from WWE where he just took his giant fucking man paw and just smacked it on the windshield of a Jeep and just shattered it. It was like,
he's like, he's that's a ridiculous. Huge fucking guy.
It's like four times the size of my normal human hand, just like eight times the size of Donald Trump's hand.
Your hand's not the size of a normal human
Shut
hand.
Shut up. You're smaller than me.
Not the way it looks on camera.
Damn it. Go fuck yourself, Jeff. next up, Michael Shannon and Michael B. Jordan are joining the cast. Damn, he does have abs. That's a fucking Michael Shannon and Michael B. Jordan join the cast of Fahrenheit 451 at HBO Films. Jack, you are the most avid reader because black people aren't allowed to have books in school.
I thought you said because black people don't read.
All right.
God damn it.
We don't.
I'm just going to sit here and wait for your question.
Yeah, no, you're not allowed to say anything.
Continue.
I'm sure you've read Fahrenheit 451. Mm-hmm. See, I told you. Any of you guys ever read it?
I don't even know what it is.
All right, there we go.
It's about...
It's pretty hot.
Jack, tell us about the story. I know. Like
that's like water boiling twice over.
Are you an electrical engineer top of your class at NYU?
Would you like me to do the Reading Rainbow Minute here for a second? Okay. So Fahrenheit 451 is about, I don't even think it's like maybe the near future now. It's about like an alternate future where essentially they burn books because there's too much learning to be had from books. Somebody's allowed to have books. And the Fahrenheit 451 refers to the temperature that books burn at, that they'll light it at a flame apparently. So it's about a guy who is, his job is to be a fireman. And that means he rolls around with a flamethrower and burns up books wherever they find them.
And that's Michael B. Jordan's character, by the way.
And it's about what happens.
Guy gotta be the one to burn the books.
See, he was like, I don't want to read
because he's religious.
But actually, that plays into the story, of course.
Did he burn the Bible?
Spoilers for a novel that's been around for 100 years. But
the only book they don't burn.
The fireman ends up taking a book home one day from a book burning, and the repercussions of that event are what lead to the rest of the story.
And it's the Bible. Oh,
very cool.
It's
the Bible's involved.
It's basically from – this is going to sound ridiculous, but it feels to me like this is sort of the inspiration for Equilibrium. They kind of stole the sort of general story.
Yeah. Well, or any kind of Orwellian
– right.
Dystopian novel.
Does Fahrenheit 451 have yes or just a quick yes or no? Does it have gun kata or no?
Does it have book kata?
It's lacking because it doesn't have gun kata.
That's why
book kata would be awesome. Have you ever seen somebody get smashed in the face with a book in a movie? I think Jason Bourne's done that a couple times. Yeah,
the Bourne identity. He beat somebody with a newspaper.
Yeah, I was about to say. Didn't he beat Clive Owen with a magazine or something like
what
that?
Was it Clive?
No, Clive Owen was a sniper. Yeah.
I think he killed him with a pen.
Oh, okay. Man, those good movies times. Used to be good.
Yeah, you remember that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the first one.
Now they cure insomnia.
Dude, I fucking passed out trying to watch the third one. I was just like, they were the like, that's Jason Bourne. I was like, gone. I woke up and I was like, it's still on. There's still more shaky cam.
The Jeremy Renner one has a really interesting setup, but then it just kind of peters off into nothing. Yeah,
right. That's what I thought. Yeah, they just take drugs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They take pills. That's all it was. I'm like, well, you're not fucking special. Well, fuck you.
Well, I want to take those drugs.
You guys excited to see a movie about a book that you don't have any idea what it is or care about in any way, shape, or form?
Yes. Because it's got Michael Shannon and Michael B. Jordan in it.
Exactly.
And you know what? Watching TV is better than reading. yes. If I'm being honest. And that's a sad indictment on the American education system. Fuck books.
Cool.
Fuck a book. They already, quote DMX. He did say that in the movie.
What?
Did he say that? Yeah, he said that in Belly. Yeah. Yeah. Mm, fuck a book. He said it to Nas, which when you watch that movie, you go, well, I guess he followed his advice.
Yeah.
Going to Africa.
I thought they made this into a movie already.
I feel like they probably have. I mean, I think there's a lot of, there's at least certainly movies that have copied that trope, like we were saying.
I mean, I thought there was a movie called Fahrenheit 451.
Probably.
There might have been.
Yeah.
Or am I thinking of like?
I think you're thinking of Fahrenheit like 9/11.
Maybe.
Fahrenheit
9/11. It wasn't called Fahrenheit 9/11, but it was like a 9/11 movie.
Flight 93?
Maybe.
But Nicolas Cage?
Or you're thinking about Indigo Prophecy, the European name.
Are you just having a stroke right now? Are you just naming random things at this point?
It's called
or are you thinking about Oscar Myers and their hot dogs?
Yes.
What are you thinking about?
Yeah, I do kind of want a hot dog. Thanks a lot, Jackie.
Yeah, you're welcome.
451, 1966.
There you go. Classic that everyone knows.
Have you seen that one?
No. Like, I just knew it was a movie.
Are you excited to see Michael B. Jordan light books on fire?
Yes.
I wish he was not the one lighting the books on fire, because I just feed into the stereotype that black people don't read.
Do you read?
They just burn books.
451.
I told you I didn't know what the fuck it was.
Okay, well, that's all right. When somebody writes a column about it, you're not going to read it anyway. So,
read what now?
Yeah, someone writes a think piece about it.
Well, I ain't reading this shit.
I'm going to write the think piece. Why the goddamn nigga burning books? Like, that's erasure. Of books
it is.
That black people read.
Think about it. Going.
Yeah.
Look, all you have to do is just point to your head.
I like, can't read a book if it's burnt.
Yeah. Roll safe.
Stupid ass shit.
That's true.
Next up, Captain Marvel finds directors in Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck. Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck both, they've done two or three films together. I don't know if you guys have seen Half Nelson with Ryan Gosling.
I've seen bits and pieces.
It's a good movie. They directed that, and they also directed Mississippi Grind with Ryan Reynolds and
I remember that.
The dude from the dude who's in Rogue One, who was like the villain in Rogue One. I forget. Mendelsohn. I forget his name. Scott Mendelsohn? I think that's right. Scott Mendelsohn, who's a very good actor, by the way. He was also in that Netflix show, Bloodlines. Look, both of those movies are pretty good. I would say are actually very good. So, and they also have done directing work on The Affair, which I've never seen, and Billions, which Billions is a great show on Showtime. So they're directing this. That's fine. It's a good directing team.
Yeah.
I got no problem with it.
Again, until they fuck up, Marvel can do no wrong. Well, I feel like they may have fucked up on
Iron Fist. But they haven't fucked the movie.
Seen 20 minutes. So
that is accurate. They fucked up. That is 100% correct. However, they haven't fucked up on the movies yet. So they got a little bit more time. Next up, Netflix.
I don't even want to talk about this shit.
Yo, this story is absolutely insane to me.
It's upsetting. To say the least.
So many people were wondering why the fuck Netflix got a deal with Adam Sandler for four movies. Like, it's Adam Sandler. His movies are terrible. And that is correct. However, apparently Netflix users have spent $500 million with a B hours watching Adam Sandler movies on Netflix. $500 million. And I don't even think his latest one.
Netflix movies.
I don't know, man. I feel like he's like the Jerry Lewis of our time, right? Like the French really love Jerry Lewis, and everyone else is like, these movies are kind of dumb.
I mean,
I think people actually like it. Well, apparently people like fucking Adam Sandler, which is
from the 90s, right? Like
No. And the Ridiculous Six and the Do-Over, which are new movies, are the most watched Netflix movies.
Well, that's what I was trying to say, though. Like, back in the day was when
he was super popular.
He was on like Saturday Night Live, and he had like the water.
Yeah, who the fuck even still knows who Adam Sandler is anymore?
Apparently, a lot of Americans.
Well,
but you also have to remember that's internationally too. This is not. I don't think this is just in America.
Yeah, people are dumb.
Yes,
his movies are not good. I haven't seen the do-over or whatever the fuck else he's
Ridiculous
done.
Ridiculous Six. I'm not watching
that. They don't look funny.
No, I refuse to watch either.
I feel
of those
like
movies.
That's why we have Trump as president, because people like Adam Sandler movies.
I think that there is a direct line of correlation.
There is no correlation between Adam Sandler and Trump, I don't think.
I think if you watch an Adam Sandler movie and laugh hysterically, you probably voted for Trump.
I think that if you watch an Adam Sandler movie and laugh hysterically, you probably can't vote for Trump because you're a teenager, because that's the only people that Adam Sandler is funny.
Point. That's a valid.
Jack fucking kicking these points in the balls, man.
Like, no. I'll tell you why this is wrong. It's valid points.
So it's a bunch of teenagers watching. No.
Yeah, that's all it is, man.
I believe it.
Oh, you think the teenagers are the demographic for these movies?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody's got Netflix.
Everybody has Netflix.
And teenagers are stupid.
That's true.
And they like stupid. Like a kid would do that shit. A kid will laugh at that shit.
He doesn't do that shit anymore.
He doesn't?
No.
How do you know?
I don't know. Actually, exactly. I don't. You're right. I don't.
Did you watch Ridiculous Six?
Ridiculous Six, didn't you? Didn't you?
No.
Didn't you? Like, baby.
Have you seen Pixels yet?
No, I haven't seen
Pixels. Oh, God.
Well, I have not seen an Adam Sandler movie since
Little Nicky.
That's the worst.
Like Big Daddy.
That's the one I've seen.
Oh, it was really bad.
Billy Madison is still funny.
Billy Madison is funny. The Waterboy is funny.
Happy Gilmore has its moments.
Yep. And that's basically it for me.
Which one was Bob Barker in?
Happy Gilmore.
Happy Gilmore.
I liked Punch Drunk Love a lot when he went dramatic.
I did
that
not
was
care
pretty
for that
good movie.
Movie.
He did another dramatic turn I liked.
Recently, this movie that he's doing now with Jennifer Hudson, I think it has a bit more of a dramatic role to it.
He's in a movie with Jennifer Hudson?
Yeah, Wexler or whatever the fuck strange. It's called.
It's didn't he pairing. Do a movie with Don Cheadle? Or
yes, yeah.
Terrence Howard, one of them.
No, it was Don. That's fucked up. They're literally on the opposite spectrum of black people.
Yeah, they are, but I feel like he did a.
No, it's the one where Adam Sandler's wife and kids maybe die in. This is a light movie. Die during 9/11, and it was a pretty serious movie, and Don Cheadle is his best friend, trying to help him out. After
oh, that. I remember that.
It's like
I've never watched.
Here comes
a
9/11
the boom
movie. Or something. I don't know. Who cares?
That's got the fat guy.
Yeah, that's Kevin James.
Kevin
can wait.
That's the name of his new show.
Is it?
I think so.
I bet he can't.
Yeah. We need to talk about Kevin.
That's a good movie.
I never saw that movie. Did you
that's
guys see
a
that?
Good fucking movie sure, starring man. The Flash, dude. That movie's fucked up.
It's fucked up.
Yeah, and after you watch it, go, yeah, we kind of do need to talk about Kevin.
We need to drown Kevin in a bathtub, from what I understand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking let's see. Throw Kevin into the fucking forest when he's an infant. Get rid of you see if you can make it back. Bye. Next up, the full roster of the New Warriors TV show has been revealed.
Is this animated?
No, this is live action.
What?
Yeah, so...
are you serious? They're going to do a live-action Squirrel Girl?
That is correct.
Oh, Carrie's doing backflips.
Oh, yeah. So, obviously, Squirrel Girl, they already announced. The other characters are Mr. Immortal, who is described as the team troublemaker and sort of like ladies' man. Dwayne Taylor, a.k.a. Night Thrasher.
Names.
Night Thrasher.
Dude, I used to have a couple of Night Thrasher comics. When they decide to give that character a solo book for maybe
who the
four
fuck
books.
Is Night Thrasher?
He's black. Shut up.
Oh.
Yeah,
of course, because he has night.
Exactly.
Black,
dark,
night, whatever.
Dark black, Thrasher, yeah. Black Thrasher. Look, racist. Just
Jigaboo
like
Flasher. Like what?
Look, just
that's
like,
over the line. That's a little too. You can't go that far.
African American.
You got to bring it back a little bit.
Look,
it's too obvious.
If Terrence can go see Steel in the theaters, I can have my Thrasher comics, Night Thrasher comics. I think that's fair. Speedball, which is not surprising. Microbe, who can talk to germs, which makes him almost like basically a telepath.
I was waiting for that. So look, I was waiting for it.
This nigga can talk to germs.
No, this is actually a cool power because they utilize it so he can touch you and see where you've been, who you've talked to.
AIDS. No, he can talk the
you
bacteria.
Don't get AIDS from germs, right?
No,
you get AIDS.
That's did you just say I don't know how you get AIDS?
Wrap your shit up, son.
Like, since you don't know, be careful.
He can't make, whatever. What is his power?
So basically, like, you know, everybody has like bacteria all over them. So yes. He can talk to that bacteria or germs on you and find out like where you've been, who you've been hanging out with, all this, like what would you do? So like you can't lie around him basically. So he's kind of he can basically like read your mind for the most part.
I don't fucking get it.
It's an interesting power. Yeah. I mean, at least it's different. It's
something different.
Yeah. It's not. It's very different.
It's not super strength or
run fast
or right. Yeah, right. Like those are the super basic.
I can talk to the germs on your body. Like that's gross.
He's just fucking.
He's kind of a germaphobe too, which is interesting.
Yeah, he
the
is.
Character doesn't really want to use his powers. Like, he's kind of grossed out by it.
Yeah,
gross.
Yeah, like, ugh.
Debris, who has a superpower of low level telekinesis, and she is a trickster. Whatever the fuck that means.
Yep.
So she like calls people on their bullshit. So like knowing Hollywood, they will cast her as a Latina woman, I'm sure.
Mm.
They're like, oh, she's fiery. Like, all right, fuck you, Hollywood. But so yeah, those are the characters, which is kind of cool. All right, let's move into movie and TV news this week. I can't believe I have to say this out loud. Fast and the Furious is... has the largest opening weekend in movie history, making F. Gary Gray the greatest director of all time.
We're going to discuss this. Yeah.
Yeah, no, we have to talk about this. It beat Star Wars. Now, it beat Star Wars only because it opened in China and the U.S. on the same day, right? And Star Wars did not have that luxury.
That's Star Wars' fault.
It is. What do you think about the Fast and Furious being the greatest example of American might?
I am fine with it. Muscle cars and cars.
And people of color?
And people of color.
I mean, I think
melting part of a movie.
I think that probably is the most interesting part of this, is that you have Black, Latino, whatever Corinne Bailey Ray is. whatever the fuck Vin Diesel is.
British black.
Vin Diesel is like all of them. Vin Diesel is the Browning of America. He's got a little bit of everything in there. Like all of those characters are now the leads of the most popular movie as far as opening weekend of
right.
all time.
Right.
That's I think that's pretty significant, but it sort of flies in the face of what we've been told about from Hollywood, which is like
minorities don't sell movies.
Yeah, minorities don't sell movies.
And women. There's three main female leads in that.
Right. Yeah. And you know, one of the other things about that series is that the female leads are not like, oh, I mean, yeah, they're attractive because like everyone in the movie is attractive. Like that's the point, right? I guess some people would argue, but like not only are they attractive, but they actually hold their own in those movies. Like it's not like Letty is like, oh, Dom, save me. No, she's like, let me shoot this. I mean, she shot fucking Vin Diesel two movies ago in the shoulder. It was like, fuck you. Bam. Yeah. So she punches people. And
man, you know, she got the short end of the stick. Now she's mothering somebody else's baby.
Yeah, it's a little... I didn't care for that part, but...
I never bought the Letty Dom relationship.
Really?
Really?
Yeah. That seems classic.
Maybe in the first movie.
They seem awkward together, especially in this movie.
Mm-hmm. I agree with you.
It's like...
I feel like Michelle Rodriguez is really a lesbian.
Yeah,
that's kind of part of it. Yeah, thing, she you know is.
And she's not a strong enough actress to pull off the whole I'm into dudes.
Yeah, she's kind of like, oh, man. Right. I love you.
Right,
oh,
right, yeah,
son
buddy.
Of a bitch.
Like, what would it be like for you to have a baby? Like, don't you mean you have a baby? like, no. What would happen if you had a baby? What would it be like if you were a father? With you? No. Just what would it be like if you had a baby and then I kind of watched it sometimes? Because I don't want any part of that.
Like, I don't want to mess up these abs I got going.
That's kind of the vibe I'm getting from that's this fair. Character.
Well, she's never actually...
And look, I don't give a fuck what she is. What she is.
No, of course not.
I give a fuck that she can't act well enough for me to think that she's into Vin Diesel.
Look. As far as her career has gone, she's always played a tough chick. Apparently, in the last movie...
She's about to play a dude.
I think that movie... Did it already come out?
I hope so, because I would love to see it.
Oh, yeah. What is it called?
Like,
The Assignment?
It was originally called The Reassignment.
Yeah.
And they were like, nope.
Like, this feels... untenable, guys. We're not going to be able to take the fucking onslaught of think pieces.
I'm curious to see that, though.
Yeah, I'm very curious to see that movie.
The first
time I've been excited to see a
transgender hero.
A Letty movie. What the hell is her name?
Michelle Rodriguez. Movie. Well, here's the thing about Michelle Rodriguez. I like Michelle Rodriguez.
Do you guys remember her first movie?
No, I mean like. No. How are you doing, Michelle Rodriguez? I find her tough, like the tough chick attitude. I feel like it's not that much of an act. Yeah. If you're watching, Michelle, you could get it.
I was just going to say, she doesn't think about you at all.
No, I know she doesn't. And that's fine.
And I think she doesn't want it.
No, I clearly not.
I think she would be a nice, a cool person to have a beer with if I drank.
I would have several Coronas with Michelle Rodriguez.
Yeah. She's never necessarily made her sexuality public.
No, I've seen interviews with her, and she's like, I like what I like, and they're like, what does that mean? Like, and she's don't like, worry like, about like it. And right. She walked out.
Mind your fucking business.
Yeah, right.
And that's fine.
Business.
It's like, what's that interview with Tom Hardy? Do you ever see that when he was promoting Mad Max Fury Road? And because you know he had done a couple of like racy like film shoots and shit back in his younger days, and like I think there was a couple of interviews where he was like, like I go both ways, like, but he's like married with kids to a woman now and everything else. And somebody asked him during one of the promotions, like in front of a huge crowd, and they were like, about your like sexuality, and he's like, they're like, you know, do you find it hard for people to talk about their sexuality in Hollywood? And he's like, what are you going on about? And he's like, are you asking about my sexuality? And the guy's like, yeah. And he goes, why?
Right.
And just embarrassed the guy. And he was like, no questions. Like,
don't touch me.
Yeah. And he was just like, why? Why the fuck do you care? And he was kind of like, all right. I mean, it was just kind of like, and clap for fucking Tom Hardy.
Yeah. Because
he fucking made you look like an asshole. Like, who cares the fuck, dude?
Yeah. Who cares?
Look, that's what Tom Hardy. Look, Tom Hardy's a good actor. I will see Tom Hardy in anything. Like, he wants to make out with a dude in his personal time or in a movie. I don't give a fuck. I don't care. And the same for Michelle Rodriguez. If she wants to make out with a woman, I will watch it. Again and again.
How do you feel about her acting?
What?
All right. That's my point.
No, look, her acting is... It's okay.
It's fine.
How did we get here from talking about how Fast 8 has suddenly become the most popular movie of all
time? Because that's what we do. The show is made in a tangent.
Just curious.
Perfect. I mean, yeah, basically.
Last Jedi should overtake this, I think. If they get that Chinese.
If China opens on the same day, it'll... If China opens the same day,
they might. They have an Asian like character in it now.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Ooh. Wait, who?
There's an Asian girl who's like a janitor or something like that. And she's going to be a character in the movie.
She's a janitor. Janitor in real life or a janitor in the movie? She's a space janitor?
Yeah.
She's a space janitor.
Finn's character, only fucking Asian.
He is a space janitor.
He's not a space janitor. He worked in sanitation. He could be an engineer.
Sure.
He's a space janitor.
He's a garbage man. He's the Rock of the Star Wars universe.
And not Dwayne Johnson.
Charles Dutton of the Star Wars
universe.
Oh,
that's taking it way back. People don't remember that show.
I do.
Everybody remember that show.
Whoa, Rock.
They did it live. They did that live one time.
Yeah, for a whole live. Fucking season.
Was it a whole season live?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
#That's Black Excellence, too.
Pretty good.
Yeah, they did good. So Kevin Feige explains why they're not going to make a R-rated Marvel movie. Basically, he was like, look, the Wolverine and Deadpool did really well because they were true to the characters and the style of the comics, not so much because they cursed a lot. So he was like, humor is our key, and that's what keeps our movies popular.
Do it, buddy.
Yeah. Like, look, I don't need them to suddenly try to like make this hard turn to the right and like make everything X-rated and all that. It's not necessary.
Yep.
Clearly, it seems to be working.
They like money. Like, did the Wolverine make $1 billion?
No, but I think it actually, I need to check, but I think it did pretty well.
Oh, I'm sure it did.
Yeah.
Didn't get any of my money.
No, I know, but even if it was PG-13, it wouldn't have mattered.
No. Right. No. No.
I still haven't seen it.
No.
Yeah. Logan?
Yeah.
That was good.
Yeah. Surprising.
That's what I've heard.
Next up, this is weird. They're making a King Kong TV series.
All right.
I feel like Harry and Henson's.
He's not going to be at a house. Very large.
Harry and the Hendersons.
I did not care for that show.
What show was that?
That was a movie.
It they was. Did a TV show as well.
I thought it was a TV show also.
It was.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
John Lithgow was in it.
Yeah. He was the father.
Hmm.
Was he in the show?
He was on the show.
He was
in the movie.
He was on the show at least. Well, he might have been in both. It might have been, you know, same thing. Same cinematic. The Harry and the Henderson cinematic universe.
I saw that in the movie theater.
You did?
Yeah. I didn't like Harry and the Hendersons, and I didn't like Alf, which felt like
Alf was fucking weird though. Yeah,
yeah. Like I know a lot of people were like really hardcore. Right? He ate cats.
Yeah, he ate cats. I mean, he was doing the world a favor, but at the same time, like the show was odd.
Yeah. Do you know how it ended?
No.
It basically ended with like everybody dying and Alf getting captured by the federal government, with like the underlying message being that they were going to dissect him.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
God,
look
damn.
It up. It's fucking awful. It's almost as bad as the show Dinosaurs. You remember that show?
Yeah. I hated that,
that show. Ended with the extinction of the Earth and all the main characters dying.
You sure?
Yep.
That time period was very odd for sitcoms.
I did not care for. I hated the dinosaurs. I did that, not like
it. It ended with the meteor coming down.
I hated the baby. He was annoying.
Stinking all life.
Good.
Good. Yeah,
right.
That was great.
Not the mom.
Remember Small Wonder?
Yes.
Oh, with the
little robot.
The robot.
Yeah.
Vicky.
Yeah, Vicky.
I didn't remember her name.
It was a very, very odd time for television back then.
Sort of was.
It was. She lived in a closet. And I remember people used to make up the rumor. Jack, I know you've heard this. They used to make up the rumor that the little boy in that show was Billy Corgan from Smashing Pumpkins.
I have heard that.
What the fuck? They were like, it's him. Because he looked like him. Like, he really did. It is not true.
The 80s was a really interesting time. Mr. Belvedere. Stories about white butlers.
Yeah, I was fine with that.
Fucking fantasies and shit.
Was that like a dream sequence?
It was a dream sequence to Benson. that was Mr. Belvedere was Benson's dream.
That is like the most 80s thing you've ever said.
One day.
Good times.
Next up, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 will have 5 post-credit scenes.
That seems a little gratuitous.
Yeah, isn't that like half a movie? Like, what is...
It's apparently like 14 minutes worth of after credit scenes. So...
For what?
I don't know.
We're going to find out.
That's very weird.
My guess is they're probably pretty short. Like, probably almost... It'll be like each character or like one or two characters will get an end credit scene of some sort. And then they'll have like a big one that sort of brings you into like Thor Ragnarok or something like that.
Yep.
That's my guess. But yeah, 5 post-credit scenes. Look, they must really like fucking Guardians 2. Like, they are... To give it 5 post-credit scenes and then the other news we'll talk about, which is the third one and them already announcing the third one.
Right.
Disney and Marvel had an open house and a bunch of journalists were allowed to go see, you know, the campus or whatever. They were allowed to see... All of Guardians 2.
Oh, really? I hadn't heard that.
Yeah, they were allowed to see all of Guardians 2. They were allowed to look at concept art from Captain Marvel and a lot of concept art from Black Panther.
Oh, and like also and Ant-Man and the Wasp.
Ant-Man and the Wasp and Thor. Like they got to see like clips of Thor and dailies from some of the other movies.
Yeah, I heard they saw dailies from Black Panther.
Yeah. And people are flipping out about Black Panther.
Yeah. So, like, the fact that they've shown that much, and especially of Guardians and seeing the whole thing,
yeah,
they are super confident in these movies.
All right. Now, of course, everybody's still under embargo, but yeah, like, people, they wouldn't have shown that movie.
No.
They wouldn't have said, hey, reporters, come on in.
Right.
You know what I mean?
If they were worried about it.
If they were worried about it.
No, they got it.
And which is, it's interesting how right you are, because like Ghost in the Shell just came out and all the press screeners got canceled like a week ahead of time. Yeah. That was really interesting.
Right. Like they want people, like Disney knows what they're doing.
Yep, no worries.
They look, and you know, I know people say, oh, the Marvel movies are formulaic or what have you, but you know what? That formula is fucking working.
Yeah.
If you don't like it, stop going.
Yeah, right. Stop buying tickets. They'll stop making them.
Yep. Next up, the Man from U.N.C.L.E. sequel is in the works. I'm actually very happy to hear this because I actually really enjoyed the first one.
I did too. It was surprisingly good.
Yeah, it was fun. I mean, it was basically Batman versus Superman.
Yeah.
I mean, like, literally Armie Hammer was supposed to play Batman at one point, and Henry Cavill is Superman. So
you haven't seen it, Terrence?
No.
It's good.
It's a fun. I've heard it's good. It's a fun. It won. It's funny. Like, it's actually really funny. Yeah. But it's an old school spy movie. Like, it. Like, these two rival spies, one from the U.S. and one from Russia, like, working together on this, you know, this mission. And it actually works really well.
I think Armie Hammer would have been a really good Batman.
I think he actually would. Like, seeing that movie, you're like, yeah, I get it. I never really understood it at first when people were saying that. But then seeing that movie, I was like, yeah. Like, he actually had, like, kind of an intimidating way about him. I was like, yeah, he looked like he could fucking throw you through a pane glass window.
He's like 6 foot.
He's a big fucking dude. Yeah, he's a big fucking dude.
He deserves a way better career, but he's made some bad, bad choices.
Well, he did fucking Lone Ranger.
Yeah, I was just going to say, did you even see that?
Fuck no. Nah. When I saw Johnny Depp with good. A crow on his head, I did not hear that.
I heard it was not like the Wild Wild West or anything in terms of being a fucking modern classic, but
right.
It wasn't awful from what I understand. And apparently Johnny Depp's... Tonto was one of the best parts of the movie. I mean, I'm not going to verify that by watching it because it looks like hot garbage, but some people...
I love that. I heard it was really good. No, I'm never going to see it.
Yeah, I'll no, take somebody's fair. Word for
I
it.
I will also take that same stance.
Whose word was that?
A liar.
Yeah.
a blind and deaf person.
Somebody's out there burning books right now.
Yeah, no, go see it. Last but certainly not least, in movie and TV news, James Gunn confirmed to write and direct Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3. They are clearly very confident. They like what he did because they're giving it back to him again.
Yep. Awesome. Go.
Yeah.
Be free. Run out there and do it.
Look, they released that fucking soundtrack. I looked at the stuff that's on there. I was like, yeah.
I want Nova.
Yeah.
I want the Nova Core, actually. I want the whole...
Yeah, like, I want to see them. Now, one of the things that came out today just... I don't want to spoil who, and I don't want you to spoil it either, but they did reveal who Sylvester Stallone is playing, which I think is pretty good.
Yeah.
I'm very interested to see what that's going to look like. And they also came out and said that, what's his face? Adam Warlock he was supposed to originally be in part two, and he had a big role, but they decided to pull him out because I guess too much going on. But he is absolutely in the third one.
Cool.
So at least he's coming, which is good because I think he's a big part of that team. So that's kind of a cool thing. So we'll see.
Cool.
Make sure you use our link, thenerdpocalypse.com/Amazon, to purchase anything on Amazon. When you do that, we get a little bit of a kickback. It's really great for us. Also, sign up for premium content, thenerdpocalypse.com/premium. $5 a month or $50 for the full year. When you do that, you will get... Obviously, this show in its entirety, you'll get the full video of this show every week, but you'll also get Airing of Grievances, which is a show that Micah and I host that's based on Seinfeld episodes that we have a good time and tell really personal stories. And we just recorded an episode, which is fucking insane.
Oh, it sounded real good. Yeah, I'm excited for that.
The ending. So...
You're welcome.
Yeah, that's all Micah's idea. So we have that, No Time to Bleed, which is our action movie podcast, which we're going to do a new episode here pretty soon. The Men with the Golden Tongues as well, which is our James Bond podcast. So sign up for all that. You also get full episodes of our political podcast that I host along with Andy called Look Forward, which you can get the first 30 minutes on iTunes or wherever you get podcasts anytime. All right. Next up, What the Fuck, brought to you by JTD. Micah, take it away.
The fact is, few things can successfully convey how, as a new parent, you feel about your partner after she pushes a small human out of her. But according to one dad, there is something which she might really, really, really appreciate and which might make a huge postpartum difference to her. The vaginal popsicle.
I'm sorry, what?
Also known as the ice finger, but for the purposes of this article, we will call it the vaginal popsicle.
Vaggie pop.
What is it? What is the vaginal popsicle? Well, it's no secret that a vaginal delivery can have heavy impact down there. And this dad's go-to relief measure is a frozen water-filled condom. So he basically fills a condom up.
freezes it. Like you know, one of them old school like Kool-Aid things where you put Kool-Aid in the ice cube and you stick a toothpick in it.
Yeah, you put the saran wrap over the top.
Yeah, yeah.
I never did that. I always wanted to as a kid. It seemed like a really cool idea.
It's very overrated. Okay.
That's basically what I figured.
I think I've done that one or twice.
And he Kool-Aid. Says you simply lay it lengthwise in your knickers.
So, so she puts on pants.
Yeah, she just.
Oh, I thought he was just lying. Bam.
That's why I was shaking my head, too. But that's what I thought, too. But it's actually a pretty good idea.
It actually is a pretty.
Numb your fucking vagina.
Yeah,
that's not bad. Cool that's idea. Not bad.
I thought he
was. I thought it was. I thought you were just lying.
That's what I thought, too.
Give him the old sub zero. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Like, why don't you just. If that's the method, just get one of those fucking things you chill your lunch out to. You know, you like.
Take an ice pack.
Yeah, get an ice pack.
You guys, anybody here been in the room when a baby's being born?
No, but I saw it on TV back in middle school or elementary school, and I was disgusted.
That doesn't do it justice.
No, I know. Again, I'm okay with. There's certain experiences I'm okay with.
Yeah,
not having.
Cool.
Jack, you want to talk about that?
Nope.
No, I do not.
Nope, I do not want to refer to talk about that at all. Just that I think this is probably a good idea. Probably some new moms out there that would appreciate this.
There you go.
All right.
This is weird that it's called the vaginal popsicle, though.
Yeah, I need you to pick a different name.
For JTD, though, specifically, this is like one of the least offensive stories you've ever had.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate it.
Yeah. Meanwhile, I'm over here.
Oh, fuck.
Shut up.
Tourists could become quadruple amputee after developing flesh-eating infection in Australia.
I'm sorry, what?
Terry Pareja arrived in Victoria, Australia to visit family, but his holiday quickly turned into a horror story. The father of two's leg began to swell to the point he had to walk with a limp. Unfortunately, he had to wait over the weekend to see a doctor because there is no doctor service in the town he was visiting.
Of course not.
When he went to the GP on Monday, they immediately amputated his right leg, and then they realized that they had to have his other leg amputated immediately as well.
Oh, my God.
He is suffering from a rare necrotizing, I know it's necrosis, but necrotizing fasciitis? It's a bacterial infection.
Where did this happen?
In Australia.
Nah, bro. Like, I'm never going there, man.
He got a spider bite that's melting his body away.
Again, whoever lives in Australia, why do you live there? And why do you continue to live there?
I feel like they're stuck there. Like, they want to leave.
Like, there's like spiders are like sitting on a runway. Like, no, bitch.
Right.
You're not going anywhere. Like, right.
Big enough to stop a plane, probably.
That makes me really uncomfortable.
I mean, they can fly in Australia.
No shit.
Look, if you live in Australia, get out. It's the fucking get out challenge for Australians. Just run.
What do they have there that's any good? They got kangaroos that'll box you to death and Vegemite that you got to chase down and fucking shit. Bugs that'll cause your fucking limbs
There's
to fall off.
There's nothing good there. Like, there's nothing good there.
You guys are drunks. Don't they have 4 foot tall beers or something?
Oh, like what? They have Foster's, the Australian for beer?
That's true. Yeah. And they got,
they don't even drink Foster's.
That's some American
that's
shit.
That's American shit.
Oh, they got boomerangs.
Yeah.
You can buy a boomerang on Amazon. Yeah, get the fuck out.
Do boomerangs really work?
They do.
If you could hit some with it. They're not coming back, though.
Nope. Look, here's the thing.
Back. You got to throw it right, and then you just got to hope it comes back in your vicinity.
If you hit something with a stick, do you ever see it keep flying after that?
Right.
It's circling come back to you.
It's down.
It's going to fucking fall, but if you throw it just to throw it to try to get it to come back to you, you just hope it comes back in, like, within a 10-foot radius. Because it's not a precision
item. So they don't go in a straight line and then come straight back?
No,
because it would kill you.
Well, fucking video games have lied to me.
No shit.
What are you basing your boomerang skills on Link to the Past? Yeah.
Boomerangs are dumb.
So the lesson in my story is don't go to Australia, but we
that's
already knew that.
What they do in Australia for fun? Throw sticks in the air.
Yeah.
Come back.
Drink giant
God
beers.
God damn.
Box kangaroos because there is fucking nothing else to do there.
No, you stay in your fucking house while the kangaroo bangs on your window like, come on out, motherfucker. Come on out.
I saw that video.
No, that shit was fucking horrifying. He's like,
sitting in there like fucking flexing and shit in the guy.
I know you gotta come out sometime, bitch.
It was the fucking Rock in that scene in Fast 8. He's just fucking curling a bench like, yeah, motherfucker. I'll beat you like a drum. Like, no, I'm not going outside. I don't need to go to school. All right, Terrence, you're up.
Yeah, we've seen this chick already. Glamour model with biggest boobs in Europe shocks fans with crispy brown look after extreme tanning injections.
Crispy brown. God damn.
She looks ridiculous.
Is this the one that I referenced last week?
Yes, it is, yeah. You asshole. Yeah, this is
right.
Not cool.
You said that she looks like him, right?
I you said son of a bitch. A little bit from the back.
This chick looks horrifying.
Oh my God, look. She does kind of look like you from the front now, too.
Nigga. Punch you in the face.
Yeah, uh-huh. I don't... Again, I'm glad we're waiting till our video debut for Jack to get beaten up. She looks fucking terrifying.
Now, that's awful. Yeah, no, that's offensive. That's not like, the picture I was talking about.
Is that what you think black people look like, lady?
No.
You're fucking racist.
Oh, well, that's what she thinks black people look like.
Yeah, that's
what
she thinks black people look like.
She's like, no, it looks good.
Uh-huh.
I'm beautiful.
Uh-huh. Black people with blonde hair.
I see. I now understand. That? I now understand your...
This is gross.
Why does she? Why is she black with blonde hair?
She has a mental disorder.
Well, clearly.
That's why she has boobs the size of small children.
And she's a man, right?
No. She's not trans. She's just a really ugly woman.
Oh, okay. I was confused.
It's problematic.
Good Lord, look at that.
That's hard to look at, man.
No, yo. I'm done. I'm finished. She's just a white woman that...
I would rather hang out with that kangaroo in Australia. Get out of here.
All right, so who's worse, her or Rachel Dolezal?
Ooh.
And I don't just mean in ugliness. I just mean in total awfulness.
In terms of like
her.
No, I think Rachel Dolezal.
Because Rachel Dolezal has the thought process of, well, you know, black people reject me because they just aren't on my level yet.
They're not on my black level
yet. Did she say that?
Basically.
Don't
die in a river.
I can find articles of her saying that.
Just not on my level.
Well, all right.
Like they haven't reached my level of race. Like, I understand race at a higher level than them.
I'm trans black.
I'm
transracial.
I'm doing.
Yeah, she says she's transracial.
Did she really? I thought you were making that up.
No,
that's cool. No. She said.
I'm gonna be transracial.
No, that's not
don't
a
do
thing.
That.
That's not a thing.
Time I fill out a job application from here on out, or try to apply for college.
You right, get a home, then you can do it.
Like, get it first.
Put your black on a application. See if you get a call back.
I think I might get more callbacks.
I don't think so.
I don't think that's how that works.
I mean, what are you applying to an HBCU?
feel like you're underestimating the benefits of being black.
All right, fair enough. I'll keep
big
it to myself.
Big dick basketball skills. I'm out.
That's about it. Can't grow a beard.
Dancing.
Shorter than white people.
I'm not shorter than you. I'm going to fucking stand.
Man, I totally planned this out, too, to be sitting here this whole time. Just right. A few inches in front.
All right, I'm gonna fucking video edit this and like make myself bigger in every way. All right, so my story is utterly ridiculous. Men are using Botox on their balls.
What? Those balls are as smooth as eggs.
That's exactly the joke I knew you were going to fucking make. That's what I knew. I know. So,
Miss, do you suck balls?
No. What about these balls?
Well.
So like women, you know, have been using Botox on their stupid faces so that they look like they don't have any emotions.
Right,
they don't
look
human. But apparently men are now injecting their own testicles with the same poison. By the way,
yeah, botulism.
Rat poison, isn't it?
It's some
Botox
type of
is like botulism.
Botulism.
Yeah.
All right. The shit you get when you go to a shitty seafood restaurant.
Right.
When I inject that into my balls, that's a great idea. What are you trying to lose your dick? Like, are you trying to lose it?
I'm not injecting anything into my balls
I'm not
ever.
Putting
ever.
Anything sharp.
No.
In my...
No. That feels a bit wrong-headed, as it were.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So, what does this do? Smooths
it makes
out the wrinkles on your balls.
Makes them as smooth as eggs. I don't know because
like,
my tablet's acting weird.
That doesn't make any sense.
Why would you do it? I think it's for looks.
Because you want smooth balls, man.
Yeah, the neurotoxin drug that temporarily paralyzes muscles. They
How
injected
many muscles in, do you have in your scrotum?
Few.
Not enough. Doctors, they predict the treatment, so-called scrotox.
Oh, Jesus. That's too easy.
Look, that's too, that is too easy. It's going to become very popular in 2017. New York-based plastic surgeon Dr. John Mesa has reformed Scrotox on 15 idiots in the past year alone. Although he calls the procedure, ball ironing. The effect of Scrotox is much the same as regular Botox, or ironing for that matter. The removal of wrinkles in the effect lasts about 4 months. So apparently there are women who have a problem with the wrinklage of balls. Spoiler alert, ladies, balls are wrinkled. It is what it is. You're just going to have to deal with it.
Do you know any women who have problems with your wrinkled balls?
I know at least 15 women who are like, go to that Scrotox doctor and get it done because they disgust me.
With the quickness.
Look, just fucking, look, if they have a problem with the wrinkle, just fucking grab your balls and push them up against the skin and fucking move on. They're like, look, don't they look good? I don't know. I'm not injecting my dick or my balls. Like, get out of here.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. That's just all you have to do.
This is insanity.
Wouldn't this also keep your balls from drawing up into your body when it's cold, which is like an important medical thing?
That's what the muscles do.
Yeah, like that. That's a protective method.
Right.
Your balls are like, oh, it's cold.
Like, I gotta get out of here.
What's it like?
That was really good. I gotta get the fuck out of here. I don't approve of this at all.
This is stupid.
No, never put a needle near your balls. That's
okay,
basically the answer.
Jack, look. I know we've been giving you a hard time, but I have to say this. This is the whitest thing I've ever heard. There's no way black dudes are doing this.
You don't think so?
No.
Black dudes who, Micah, who color coordinates his hat with his shirt and his pants.
He wants to
not
have
that concerned about image
balls
that you don't want your balls to be smooth as eggs.
Nah.
All right, cool.
You want to get a little, you want to know something about me? My balls are wrinkled as shit. Wrinkled, they're hairy. I pluck grays out of them. Yeah, man. Yeah. So, Nah.
Things I did not ever need to know.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Like, it's like the fucking like after school special. It's like, the more you know. Like, a fucking star. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. This costs almost $500, by the way.
What?
Fuck off.
$500 to stab a ball? Do you have to get both?
Yeah, it's probably
done?
Per ball.
Yeah, it is probably per ball.
No, that's not. It's your fucking scrotum.
No, because when they
it's
do when no, but like when they like, do well, yeah, when they do regular Botox,
you got
right?
a seam.
You got a seam. So you got.
Right, why does it have a seam?
Because it was your vagina once upon a time.
Yeah,
it fuses together because we were all women at one point.
So, okay, here is my question. No, I was
you're
just
right,
thinking.
Right.
No, that's accurate.
For
that's
a man
accurate.
Who doesn't read, you're surprisingly erudite.
You know so much. No, my question is, like, with regular Botox, like, they don't just inject your forehead once, right? Like,
oh, yeah,
they
yeah.
do it a number of times. Do you have to get, like, several fucking shots?
Well, your balls ain't that big. Well, your scrotum isn't that large, right?
Says you.
Yeah, I was going to say.
I don't know.
Sail with mine, motherfucker.
Like, I don't know
that's
who.
That's abnormal.
Like who brags about that? I've got giant balls.
Balls
like,
are so huge.
Yeah.
Got they a third one that lights
in,
up.
They get in the way when I sit down. Like, it's not a thing. Or at least I hope it's not.
If it is, I mean, Botox your balls because it's
clearly you got a fucking issue. Yeah, I'm not doing this. $500?
No, not for $10.
And look, here's the thing: $500 for 4 months. That means you got to get it done 3 times a year to keep the appearance of boiled egg balls.
Where are you at in your total fucking life, and how you feel about yourself that you were like, you know what, I got to do? I got to find $500 because I have got to get the wrinkles out of these balls. Like, where is your fucking head?
These
like,
bitches would be on me if my balls
that's
were fucking.
Right, yeah.
Like, I got a 6-pack. I got money, and they still don't want it.
Clearly, it's my balls.
It's clearly the wrinkled balls.
I got nothing. I don't know.
I don't know what's.
It doesn't make any sense.
Cool. That's cool.
Like, yeah, they're always enough. Covered up.
This is not for us. Most of these stories are not for us.
This is not for us. Trailers this week. Quickly, trailer for Cloak and Dagger.
Looks really low budget.
Yeah,
but
I mean, it's on Freeform, which is basically
ABC Family,
right?
Yeah, the dagger that she was holding was literally just like a light-up plastic
Yeah, it really was. I thought it looked okay. Look, I assume I can get Freeform on my Roku. I'll check it out.
I'll watch it.
Like, I'm not like super excited. I'm not like disappointed. I just, I don't know. What about you?
I will not watch it.
No?
No.
You're not into that Jungle Fever, is that why?
And that's the thing. I am.
According to my porn category, I'm totally fine.
One, they're too young.
Yeah.
That's
so true.
And yeah, no.
Are they teenagers in the comic book?
They're young. Like, I don't remember their background. They've been like teenagers till like 20s.
Did they both like come from the streets or like?
Yeah, they were homeless at one point.
Oh, that's right.
And that's how they
met. Okay.
And the black dude's name is Tyrone, because of course.
Of course it is.
I can say that. You can't say that. Of course it is. Fuck you, Jack. The next one is American Assassin.
This looks great.
I think this does look good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
By the way, I didn't realize this is the kid from those, what's the fucking Scorch Trials or whatever.
Oh, the Maze Runner?
Maze Runner movies.
It is that kid.
Yeah.
You're right. He's grew a beard in this.
Yeah, I'm, look, I'm the first one was like a fold your laundry on a Saturday type movie. I didn't watch the second one. I couldn't get through it. But I'm glad to see him in a movie because he got really injured. Like, they were supposed to do the third one of those Maze Runner movies. Yeah. I don't know if they are still doing it or they did do it. I have no idea.
He almost died on the set.
Yeah, he literally got ran over by a fucking car during the set. Like, he got seriously injured. They were just like, and we're just going to stop.
Yep. We're wait just for you. Literally not going to make this movie now. Yeah.
So it's good to see he's back. I'm glad he got better.
This looks great. Michael Keaton is basically like a CIA advisor, and this kid is like, his fiance dies and he's out for justice and he's going to go basically take down a terrorist cell by himself, and the government's like, cool, come on in, we'll help you.
Yeah, that's a weird recruiting process, but all right.
And he's like skinny young Jason Bourne in this, basically.
Yeah, it looks good. Like, the action looks pretty visceral and stuff like that. I'd see it.
Some John Wick style of handgun cocking action.
Yeah.
Gun kata.
I'm down with it.
Yeah.
And then lastly, Star Wars The Last Jedi came out.
Fuck that. Who wants to see this?
Yeah, I'd rather see Cloak and Dagger.
Speaking about franchises that don't make any money.
Oh, yeah, right. I mean, it's only second to
Fast fucking Star Wars. What do you want?
Yeah, I think this trailer looks good. I mean, the highlight for me was seeing that fucking pan around the mountain shot of Rey practicing with the lightsaber with Luke watching. I thought that was a fucking cool moment.
Did you notice that they changed Kylo Ren's scar, his face scar?
Yeah, it's on.
It's over his eye now instead of like just being down the middle of his face, which is what it was in the first.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, okay. The director Rian Johnson.
Did he have a scar in the front?
Remember, she cut his face. Yeah, she cut his face all up. And the director was like, that looked ridiculous, so we changed it.
All right, whatever.
All right.
I don't give a shit. Look, I want, and they did a good job of like sort of covering the lower part of his face. Like, you could see the scar, but you couldn't see all. I hope his face is fucked up. Because look, he's going to the fucking dark side. He should be, like, that's a trait of the dark side, is like, your body starts acting fucking weird, and like, your jaw falls off and shit like that.
I like that this is a trailer that gives away very little for being 2.5 minutes long. Yeah. You know?
I thought it was a well-done trailer. I dug it. Micah?
Rose worked in maintenance for the Resistance and gets pulled into an adventure with Finn. Rian Johnson likened her to Luke. There you go. Asian janitor.
All right. Space janitor.
Space janitor.
For the win.
There you go.
Terrence, your thoughts?
Is Finn in this?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'll see it.
There you go.
Is the black guy in it from the first?
Yeah.
All right.
It looks good, man. It looks good.
Yeah, I think
like
so.
You said, it doesn't give anything away.
No.
And it asks, you know, intriguing questions. And
why does Luke want the Jedi to end?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. Nobody wants to be a Jedi anyway.
I always do. Anyway, hold on. Yeah, this is very important to have out before we're done. So I was listening to that other show, some fucking assholes on it, and that one white guy who looks like a professional wrestler or a shitty Food Network show host. And somebody on that show, the tall black guy who does the impressions, was talking about how nobody ever wants to be a Jedi. I never wanted to be the Sith, man. In all those games, I'm always good. Always.
I am always good.
I'm good in real life. I don't need to be good in a video game.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know about that.
Open to interpretation. Let's agree to disagree. It's
fine. I'm just saying there are people out there.
No, I actually like being the Jedi.
Yeah,
like,
me too.
I do. Like, I have a weird, like, sort of moral thing. Like, in especially like KOTOR and any of those games, I could never be evil.
Yeah,
I'm like,
me either. Me either. I was never evil in that game.
I'm really? I'm a good person.
I'm always a mixture. I try to be like straight up evil, but I can't do it.
Mm.
Really?
Yeah.
I think that says more about you. Yeah.
It says I like Force Lightning, and you guys like sitting around in doo-doo brown robes, fucking talking to midget Muppets and trying to get children to come to the light, little boy. You could be one with the Force.
I'll tell you about some midichlorians.
Right, nah, man, fuck that. I like them black ass robes. I like
red lightsabers.
I like red lightsabers.
I always get either red or purple. I think, or always the lightsaber colors I choose.
And I like turning I like turning on people.
He says as he looks directly at you. Yeah. By the way, fuck this shit.
I've been waiting a long time for this reveal. Like, wow, this heel turn has been fucking significant. I guess I have a moral center. I guess that's what it is. I guess I'm a good person. Some of us aren't.
I'm a very good person.
Well, you're slightly dubious because you're somewhere in the
middle. You've been repeating that for a couple of weeks in a row. Do you have a trial coming up or something? What are you trying to get out?
If you check our YouTube channel, I did say at minute 35.
I want this on record.
All right, cool.
Don't worry about it.
Because you said it.
He's going to fucking stab someone. Terrence is literally going to...
Don't worry about it.
Terrence is literally leaving here to go stab someone and be like,
I said I was a good person. Bleed out. Bleed out. Hurry up.
I'm not a yeller.
Right.
I don't think I've ever heard you raise your voice.
Could have sounded like Brian Gosling.
Nobody look at my face.
Hey, yo, what the fuck? Look, you know what?
Oh, I have heard you. That's true.
That's it.
Never mind.
Yeah, I gotta keep it.
I'm the same way, man.
You gotta
keep it. I'll get several octaves down.
I can't yell either.
I'm not a yeller.
Like, I got to do that shit in order to yell. Even then, that's as loud as it gets.
Oh, I can yell, and it's...
my voice doesn't carry, so...
No.
I can't yell.
It's like...
It's just a fucking cliff. Boom. Everybody's like, I can't fucking hear you. I'm like, well, come closer.
don't touch me.
Come closer. Kill you. But not that close.
Arm distance.
Yeah.
All right, that is it for us. We'll be back obviously next week. Again, like we said, the video episodes will be for premium members, thenerdapocalypse.com/premium. For those of you who are not premium members, you will get clips of the shows going forward, funny ones from the episodes that we think that you'd like to see. Obviously, the audio versions will be still available for free on any of the podcatching programs that you use. All right, guys, we will see you next week.
See ya.
Bye. Take it easy.
Bye.
That was awesome.